Cleveland Browns as Amari Cooper went off for 260 receiving yards. They got the Titans for the second time in 3 weeks. And in college football, the Texas Longhorns landed AAC Defensive Player of the Year, Trey Moore.
Sports Center is brought to you by Byers Barricades, the Texas Authority in Barricade Rental. ByersBarricades.com.
It's 0600. What's the O stand for? Oh my God, it's early.
Wake me up!
Wake me up!
Wake up!
Wake up!
Wake me up!
Oh, wake me up!
Wake up!
Rob Thompson.
Ginobili the other way in transition to the back with a left hand slam!
I want some nasty!
Rudy J.
Cowboys win! How else would you settle this game?
Begin each day as if it were on purpose.
I wake up in the morning, I kiss excellence.
R&R in the morning on 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star.
Good morning!
Hey, good morning to you. It's R&R in the morning, a Tuesday edition. Do not adjust your clocks. It's not Monday. It is December the 26th, the day after. No, Rudy J, but I am the host of a very special blossom. I'd like to introduce the cast and crew of the Saturday morning hangover that have gathered together yet again for a Tuesday morning hangover. He is James Pledger, sitting across from me, though, down to my right, if you're watching us live on our YouTube feed. And to my top right, that's my number one son, Jack Thompson, the Saturday morning hangover crew, back together again. I get to play referee today. Morning, gentlemen.
Morning.
Everybody good? Everybody feeling fine?
It's a Christmas Day hangover.
Yeah,
day after Christmas hangover.
Well, we will get it going. Easy E, Edwin Hafner on the other side of the glass. Good morning to you, sunshine.
Morning.
Yeah, we're all kind of surly, but we represent, I think, what most people would represent right about now. So if you're up and at them, we're glad you're with us. Don't mind them brake lights. We'll get you where you're going. We do have a lot to get into today if we manage to find the sporting world. Cowboys lose and what was is it another one of those bad football games that was good because it was close, or was it a good football game? We'll talk about it. Watch San Francisco get put in their place, or just tired and really not needing it last night as Baltimore took care of business. Everybody else good? Anything else to add to this as I watch my two co-hosts nod off?
Well, I'm just, I was letting you set the scene.
Okay.
I was just trying to figure out where we were starting this morning on the, the day after Christmas. And
I want to get a rundown. If you are listening or watching on your device, pipe in, say something.
Was it you like to say,
let us know.
Sound off like you got a pair?
Sound off like you got a pair, because let us know we're not in this alone. Because I get the sense, judging by the traffic I went through this morning, that... There's nobody else up. There's no one else up. We're the only human. Us and the poor garbage men. Bless your hearts, guys. We're with you today.
That's tomorrow for you, right?
Well, no, today. Well, yeah. Today, the garbage guys go to work today. You know what I mean? And the mountains of boxes and Amazon things that have been hidden in closets and underneath beds for the last 3 months, it's all going out front.
I did not pass a car on my way to work.
No, I
know, not a single
one. So normally when I get up on where I'm coming down, I always see it's me, the garbage men, and cement trucks. We're the only guys up. And every now and then I run into a couple of doctors at the Valero, but normally they've been woke up and are heading in. But for the most part, it is desolate out there this morning. So we'll do our best to take you all the way through.
I did feel alone this morning.
Yeah.
Oh, I come in for and quite a bit lately, this 4 a.m. shift, and especially from my remembrance of it, there's people on the road usually.
No. Not now.
Not today, no.
So did everybody have a Christmas that was worthy of remembrance?
Yeah, yeah. They're all worthy of remembrance,
well,
right?
I mean, both
time with loved ones, and I mean, I have an issue with church right now, but
you have an issue with your church, like in general,
like
your fist up.
What's the point? So I Sunday morning, I go to mass, right? Sunday morning, 10 a.m. mass. Apparently that didn't count for Christmas mass.
So you had to go back.
I had to go back on Christmas Day at 10 a.m. because like the Christmas mass was like the 6 o'clock or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
So the 10 o'clock on Sunday morning didn't count. You had to go to the 6, which I wasn't skipping football.
What, were you told that at the morning mass? Like a part come two, back. If you want to get your ticket punched, you're going to have to come back and sit through at least one meal.
Yeah. You have to make it through at least. I was very disappointed in finding out about the workaround to get me there on Christmas Day.
You know, there was a time when our family used to hustle around and try to make the, we're not Catholic, so the Christmas Eve.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, the midnight, whatever you want to call it.
Yeah.
The railroad workers, we're with you, my brother. Thanks for jumping on with us. We don't do that anymore. It became a, you know, you're trying to go with God and try to go to church and, you know, get that love and feeling. But all it turned into was about a 3-hour fight just to get everybody ready, get them to the church. Find a place to sit, get it all done without any kind of hassle. So we just kind of gave that up. If you want to go on your own, we're not going to organize a traverse with 15 people ever again.
What? Yep. You don't enjoy the goat rodeos?
No, but it just became such a point of contention that we were like, you know, let's not, why are we doing this to ourselves?
And then trying to find a spot where all y'all can sit together.
So we always ended up late. There was half of us that wanted to be there early so we'd actually get to sit in a good seat. Said we're like the spillover room in the kindergarten class with a video projector on the wall. No. No. We could watch. I could watch Joel Osteen at home with a better seat. You here with us this morning, Jack?
I'm here.
Okay. Just want to make sure.
I'm here.
All right. Let's talk some Cowboys. They did go down. Was there anything to pull from this game other than they still cannot stop the run?
We held them to a bunch of field goals. The presumably best offense besides what we thought was San Francisco before last night.
So the Cowboys go down to Miami. Philadelphia does not do the same to New York, although the Giants made it interesting at the very end.
They did.
Who are the beneficiaries of a very interesting week of football? The Cowboys go down, but did they go down very far? It doesn't appear that way. R&R in the morning continues next. This is 94.1 here on San Antonio Sports Star.
San Antonio Sports Star.
Mr. W Fireworks is home to the absolute lowest priced fireworks around. Locally owned and operated right here in South Texas, the Wildman family has been selling beautiful memories since 1966, and they are dedicated to providing our area fireworks at the most affordable prices. In fact, Mr. W Fireworks are traditionally 50 to 80% lower than other providers in the area.
50 to 80% lower prices. Now that's a lot of savings.
Well, thank you, Claire and Jonah. That's the Mr. W younger generation. Shop early with Mr. W Fireworks and you can save even more.
Buy one, get one free on select items at all Mr. W Fireworks San Antonio locations.
Visit MrWFireworks.com to find a location near you.
MrWFireworks.com.
You heard him. MrWFireworks.com. Just look for the big W on the sign and you can be confident that you will be getting the best prices on your fireworks only at Mr. W Fireworks.
From our family to yours.
Happy New Year!
At Lowe's, save big every day when you buy in bulk. Get 10% off select concrete mix when you buy one pallet or more. Plus, save an extra 5% every day on eligible purchases when you use your Lowe's business credit card. Visit us in-store or online for low prices on the materials you need. Because Lowe's knows savings. Lowe's knows pros. Selection varies by location. While supplies last, discount taken at time of purchase. See sales associate for details. 5% offer subject to credit approval. Exclusions and terms apply. See store at Lowe's.com/credit for details.
A holiday message from Jackson Hewitt.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to get money the same day.
Starting December 11th, walk into a Jackson Hewitt for an early loan on your tax refund, and you could walk out with up to $1,000.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to get money. Missing out would be cray.
Appointments go fast. Book yours now at JacksonHewitt.com. Early refund advance offered to eligible clients. Application required. Finance charge applies. Loans by Republic Bank. Details at JacksonHewitt.com.
Honey, come here, quick.
What is it?
Shh, check it out. The prices on all these highly rated tequilas are amazing. Total Wine must have made a mistake.
Nope, they always have the best deals in town. Remember that amazing Reposado your sister brought over last week? See, it's right here.
Whoa, that's a low price. I mean, whoa, that's a low price.
With the lowest prices for over 30 years, you'll always find what you love and love what you find. Only at Total Wine & More. Drink responsibly. B21.
I feel like I'm constantly cleaning hair off my bathroom floor. At least my Swiffer Sweeper makes it easy. Sweeper Heavy Duty Dry Cloths have ultra-thick pads to trap and lock hairs, like a hair magnet. And when I'm finished cleaning up my hair, Sweeper takes care of his too. Now the hair's gone, all thanks to Swiffer. Try Swiffer Sweeper Heavy Duty Dry Cloths. I promise you'll love them or your money back. And also try Swiffer Sweeper Wet to make quick work of tough, sticky messes.
Over the past decade, the Roof Hub has proven to be the best place to watch games with those three massive 170-inch screens and TVs all around. Football, basketball, all the UFC fights. And when you show up at the Roof Hub, show up hungry. The food is fantastic. Open daily at 11. Great for lunch, great for dinner, great for late at night, and the best place to watch a game. Celebrating 10 years in business, the Roof Hub is next to the Angry Elephant there at 281 in Redland Road. We'll see you at the Roof.
Not all pizza places are the same. Mellow Mushroom originated hand-tossed, stone-baked, classic Southern pizza. Not in the mood for pizza? Order a calzone, hoagie, sandwich, burger, or a mellow salad and see how care goes into every item on the menu. Take your pick from 24 draft beers and or handcrafted cocktails. And many of the pizzas can be made gluten-free or vegan. Mellow Mushroom is at 1604 in Stone Oak Parkway. Hang with friends, watch the game, and mellow out at Mellow Mushroom.
When something happens to your kitchen, you might say,
"This is ludicrous."
But that won't fix your home. That will only get you the rapper Ludicrous.
Having trouble? Don't panic. Don't be alarmed. You need to file a claim? Holla at State Farm. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
That's right. You can file a claim on the app or call us.
Thanks, Mr. Chris.
No matter how ludicrous the situation, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
State Farm, Bloomington, Illinois.
Prescriptions require an online consultation with a healthcare provider who will determine if appropriate restrictions apply. See website for details and important safety information. Subscription required. Price varies based on product and subscription plan.
Hey guys, did you know there's a generic form of Viagra that works just the same, but is 95% cheaper, and you can get it online? Go to hims.com/joy. Through Hims, you'll get a free medical consultation, discreet shipping if prescribed, and the process is 100% online. To start your free online visit, go to hims.com/joy. That's hims.com/joy.
Get ready for the ultimate poker showdown. It's the Texas Hold'em tournament with a jaw-dropping $100,000 first place prize. Join us at the 100 Grander on Saturday, January 13th in San Antonio for high stakes action. The top finishing woman player wins $10,000 and top finishing senior and super seniors win $5,000 each. Don't miss out on the excitement. Secure your spot now at TexasHold'emSA.com to register. That's TexasHold'emSA.com to register.
Have you or a family member been arrested? The Law Office of Jesse Hernandez, the Texas Chancla, can help regardless of the legal battle you are facing, personal injury or criminal defense. Attorney Jesse Hernandez and his team are ready to fight for you. Calls are answered 24 hours a day and 7 days a week. Call 210-807-8656 or visit jessehernandezlaw.com. That's 210-807-8656 or jessehernandezlaw.com. The Law Office of Jesse Hernandez, the Texas Chancla.
Check out the Jim Rome Show, weekdays at noon.
If you're San Antonio, there are benefits that come along with it. I will cut you to the front of the line. We're going to hike the return.
On 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star.
It's R&R. Happy holidays to you. Happy Merry Christmas. And as we head toward the new year, if you're up and at 'em, thank you for joining us this morning. Some of us have to work. Some of us just trying to get away from the fam. Wake up early. Go see the moon. Full moon. Did you see that this morning?
I did see that this
morning.
I did
not see that.
You didn't? You were driving in it. It was actually out there.
It was there.
But it was interesting. Yeah, Friday night was the rib cook-off.
What's up, champ?
Yeah, I won.
Yeah.
And it was not as close as people
would. I thought Minix's ribs were good.
They were good. They weren't the best.
Rudy is.
Yours were just better.
I didn't get to try one of the award-winning ribs. I got there too late.
The sad thing is, one of the I made two sets.
I made one that's kind of my standard competition rib, although I added a bacon candy rub that was pretty interesting. And then I did another one that was like a butter herb garlic that I basted those ribs in butter for about 7 hours. Those turned out ridiculous.
Yeah, those were.
That was an interesting
one. Those are crazy good.
I couldn't do it again.
That's the disheartening part. Is I missed them and I was like, oh, you'll make them again at some point. And then you told me I could never do that again.
Yeah, that's the, you know, the difference between a cook and a chef is the ability to repeat the process. And I'm just a cook. You know what I mean? A chef would be able to do that five times in a row exactly the same way. What I did just escapes me because it's kind of like I'm winging it most of the time. Much like the Cowboys, it feels like.
Oof,
winging it most of the time because, you know, if the script was written 3 quarters and 10 minutes of football, it would have been a glorious weekend for the Dallas Cowboys. I mean, if the script was written without that last 4 minutes, it was Dak not only sealing the MVP because the touchdown pass to Cooks and then what we saw happen to Purdy, it might not have sealed it, but it would have been a two-man race at this point between Dak and Lamar. But for the warts, but for the inability to stop the run, the story had to be rewritten, though, because what would have been a glorious redemption story of a team coming back from a Buffalo loss turned into the first time in, 3 years that the Cowboys have lost 2 consecutive games. And for the, yet again, I say that, they couldn't stop the run when it mattered. And I think that's more important than the whole. They did do a pretty good job against a Miami offense that is as fast as we've seen. And Tariq Hill, for as much of a threat he is, really wasn't all that damaging.
Yeah. I mean, Tariq Hill, he only had 9 catches for 99 yards, no TDs.
So well, I mean, yeah, that's a win.
A pedestrian game for him.
Yes. And boy, we certainly were worried about him all game long. As I say, we, the if you're watching the television, on depending on the feed you chose, lots of Tyreek talk. I mean, it was every time he was up, and he would seem to, you know, he was the threat, but it was the running game. It was Mostert.
I mean, you say it was the running game. They only had 91 yards rushing.
But when they needed it, when it had to happen in the fourth quarter is when they got it. I defensively, it's one of those hidden statistic things where the numbers tell you that the defense did a pretty good job against an explosive offense, but when it came down to it, when the defense knew and the offense knew that we're running the football to grind this clock down to go win the football game, there was nothing the Cowboys had in the tank.
There's nothing that the Cowboys had in the tank, but at the same time, it's a little bit of who the Cowboys are. And I hate the they hadn't lost in almost in over 2 years stat consecutive games because – yeah, like go back and look at their schedule over the last 2 years. The last time they lost consecutive games, they lost to Aaron Rodgers and Patrick Mahomes back-to-back. Other than that, they usually have a layup after a loss. Like it was a very easy stat for them to be able to perpetuate for the last 2 years because their schedule hasn't been great.
Well, we'll hold it against them. And you're right. I mean, every game is in a vacuum and individual. But it did reinforce a narrative that is now not just a narrative. It's not just a, it's true that the Cowboys are mentally, I think physically they're a tough football team, but they're not built to do what we're asking them to do. And to overcome that, they're going to have to be a little bit tougher. And I don't know how to define that because I think they are tough. But when you lose like this consistently, it's either the yips, like you just can't figure it out, or you realize, look, we are not built to do what we're asking them to do. And this team is, they've got one linebacker.
Yeah.
The Cowboys run a defense, and this is their strong 3rd and 5 defense. This is not their 3rd and 9 nickel defense. Their 3rd and running down defense has one linebacker.
Who's a safety.
So when we ask them and wonder why they can't stop the run, well, when you're running around with five dudes that are about 6'3", 235, that can run as fast as anybody and hit as hard as anybody can pound for pound, but they just don't bring the meat. And maybe it'll change when Hankins is showing up. But this was not inside the guards running that was beating them. It was sweeps. It was off tackle. It was the motion that was, again, taking our defense, or the Cowboys defense, out of the formation they wanted to. And they have to be in perfect formation to stop the run.
Do the Cowboys know who they are?
Well, I think that they have an idea who they want to be, but who they want to be is not what is required. This is a team that was not built to stop the run. This was what Dan Quinn wanted. He got everything he needed. But it was not built to stop a third and five or a third and four pulling guard sweep. It was not built to do that.
It might have been built when we had, you know, LVE back there.
That's a true statement. But my retort to that is, as the LVE went down, and he was the best linebacker, rush defense linebacker they had, but they've had opportunities over the last 4 months since LVE went down to go augment that position and chose not to.
That's the issue with the team, though, is the way it's constructed, a la Jerry and Will McClay and even Dan Quinn, if you will, is your solution to stopping the run is to have one true linebacker and rely on that linebacker who has had a history of neck injuries.
Well, I mean, that was months ago.
I understand that it was months ago, but like, that's your plan going into the year. Your plan was, we're going to stop the run because Leighton Van Der Esch is our best run defender, although he has a history of injuries.
Well, he's one of 11. I don't fault him for this.
But he's not one of 11 linebackers.
There's not 11. There's not five linebackers on the roster, whether it was Van Der Esch or anybody. They chose, the Cowboys, to be a pass defense turnover football team.
Mm-hmm.
Which it works most of the time. But James, you have put it on the head when you start thinking about who are we? And when you decide to hang your hat on something that, quite frankly, you cannot always control, turnovers, it's a very difficult thing to mimic week to week, especially on the road. So if you want to live and capitalize on turnovers, which the Cowboys have when they're winning, and they're winning by lots of digits when they're at home, it's because those turnovers are there. That's what Quinn's defense have always been. But the Legion of Boom is not the same boom when you don't have those big safeties that he's been accustomed to having over the years.
I mean, it's not about the turnovers for me, though. It's about the identity of this team. And I don't mean this in a diminutive way. I don't, even though it's going to sound like it. This is a front-running team. And what I mean by this is a front-running team is this is a team that is built to get up on someone early, let that offense, let Dak and CD cook, get a lead, and let that defense go to town on a team trying to come back on you. Yep. Let those edge rushers get upfield and destroy you. And when they do that, you notice that team is a completely different team than the team that it is in close games.
They're built to do what they're doing. They're built to be front runners.
Yeah.
And when they don't front run, when they have to control the ball, they have trouble. And when teams can hold the ball and grind them, they don't have enough bodies. They don't have enough big bodies to stop the run. And it's the different kinds of runs that have beaten, running schemes that have beat the Cowboys. It's just not the 49ers style. That's two of the losses. The motion pulled the Cowboys out of whatever they want to do, knowing for their full well man-to-man. Or it could be the zone blocking scheme that we saw Buffalo go after. It's an entirely different scheme. And they ran all over. And then you go back to what the Cardinals did, another zone blocking idea, and took them out as well. So it's not just a style. It's any style of running game has taken the Cowboys out.
Can you take any positives, though, from this in terms of Dak goes, gets a lead late on the road, on grass, team keeps it close, and the way that they were able to basically limit a team that runs the San Francisco style of offense, and you basically put a lid on it after getting blown out by it earlier in the year?
A worthy question for both of our experts that will arrive in the, in just about an hour. We will be joined by Todd Archer. We'll ask him a question, and I think that's a worthy one. Clarence Hill will follow in Fort Worth Star-Telegram at 7:30. Now at 7:30, we got Clarence, 8 o'clock Todd. Let's do this right. So I think a worthy question is exactly that. But how wide open is the NFC now? were the 49ers exposed? And while the Eagles held on, the Giants made it interesting at the very least. How bad are the Eagles? It's not just sitting in the Cowboys' lap how things have seemed to collapse just a bit.
Yeah. And I mean, the Eagles ended up taking it to the, or I mean, the Giants ended up taking it to the Eagles a little bit. So that's kind of promising. But the 49ers, you know, there's that, what Zach Randolph also said, like, in my hood, bullies get bullied. That's totally what happened in Baltimore. They rolled 49, or the Baltimore rolled into San Francisco and bullied the bullies.
They did. And, you know, that's the kind of beating that it takes a week or two to shake off. Either it snapped them into being awake. That was a beating that it's one of those self-examination beatings.
Yeah, Brock Purdy looked like Mr. Irrelevant in that game.
Hey, coming back, we got a lot more as we talk Dallas Cowboys. 7 o'clock, we do silver and black all the time. But the gumbo is hot in the NFL as playoff positioning is rounding into form. What did we see? As Amari Cooper took down the Texans, what do we think of Flacco? Can he be an MVP conversation piece? We're looking around the NFL next. Don't go nowhere. This is R&R, and you're on 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star.
It's the Blitz with Jason and Joe. Afternoons at 2.
Coming up on the Blitz, boy, I hope everybody had a great Christmas. It was a wonderful Christmas for our family. It's good to be back. We're going to react to all of the things that happened over the weekend. Plus, we're going to get you ready for the college football playoffs. C.J. Stroud didn't play. When's he coming back? Well, Indy Kalu may have some answers for us when he joins us at 3:30.
The Blitz with Jason and Joe. Afternoons at 2 on 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star.
If you can't sleep because of annoying knee pain, that's a problem. If you stop running because your feet always hurt, that's a problem. If your elbow, shoulder, and neck pain make it impossible for you to do your job, that is a problem. And it's time to finally do something about it. I'm Dr. Jason Garrett from Erosti. At Erosti, we fix pain fast. No medications, no injections. Erosti treatment is completely natural and non-invasive. Plus, we accept most insurance plans. There's a location near you. Visit Erosti.com. That's A-I-R-R-O-S-T-I.com. Erosti, we fix pain fast.
Over the past decade, the Roof Hub has proven to be the best place to watch games with those three massive 170-inch screens and TVs all around. Football, basketball, all the UFC fights. And when you show up at the Roof Hub, show up hungry. The food is fantastic. Open daily at 11. Great for lunch, great for dinner, great for late at night, and the best place to watch a game. Celebrating 10 years in business, the Roof Hub is next to the Angry Elephant there at 281 in Redland Road. We'll see you at the Roof.
America's best high school football players are coming to San Antonio. It's the All-American Bowl at the Alamo Dome, Saturday, January 6th. Trevor Lawrence, C.J. Stroud, and Micah Parsons played here. Join us for a day of exciting football to see the stars of tomorrow at the All-American Bowl, followed by the San Antonio Sports All-Star Football Game presented by Valero. It's the All-American Bowl at the Alamo Dome, Saturday, January 6th. Tickets on sale at the Dome Box Office and Ticketmaster.
Get the home field advantage every time with Fairfield by Marriott, official hotel partner of the NCAA. Whether you're a student athlete working toward your championship dreams or your team's biggest fan, Fairfield by Marriott has everything you need to get ready for game day. From comfortable guest rooms to complimentary hot breakfast, Fairfield is part of the Marriott Bonvoy portfolio of hotels and official hotel partner of the NCAA. Visit fairfield.marriott.com to book your next game day stay.
Hey, Brent, love the color. If you had to choose, would you watch paint dry or compare benefits plans?
Compare benefits plans, obviously.
But you know how complicated benefits are, right?
Well, I run payroll with Gusto. Gusto makes it easy to find benefits like medical, dental, and vision for my whole team.
Sorry, I'm gonna need new glasses.
Don't worry, you're covered.
Choose benefits without the mess. Visit gusto.com/radio to sign up for free.
When you or someone you know is going through the process of being accused of a crime, you need a team to help you protect your innocence. Who better to fight for you than former prosecutors, now defense lawyers, that know the justice system? The LaHood Norton Law Group will defend your freedom. When you choose us, you choose honest, aggressive, trusting, expert, and fearless representation. If you need help, you need the LaHood Norton Law Group on your side.
Do you have three ex-wives and your current trophy wife wants a life insurance policy three times the size of the policies you had to purchase for your previous mistakes? If so, you need to call Big Lou at Term Provider, 800-568-2790. Big Lou is intimately familiar with your problems, and if you're 50 or 60 years old and in reasonably good health, a $1 million policy should only cost about $100 to $200 per month. Big Lou may have a solution for your previous policies as well. You may even save enough money to lighten the load on your new $1 million policy. Remember, call Big Lou. He's like you, except he's only on number two. Call Term Provider at 800-568-2790. That's 800-568-2790. For $1 million in term life insurance that you can live with, call Big Lou at 800-568-2790. Diabetes, high blood pressure, anxiety meds, everyone's on them. If you're a 50-year-old male, maybe a bit porky, and you may even have type 2 diabetes, $1 million of term insurance may only cost you about $200 a month. Call Term Provider. Speak with Big Lou at 800-568-2790. Big Lou will find a term life policy for you even if you have type 2 diabetes, are overweight, or have high blood pressure. Term Provider has helped thousands of people like you who think they can't afford term life insurance. To buy $1 million of affordable term life for you, all you need to do is call Big Lou at 800-568-2790. Lou will make sure the scales are tipped in your favor. Call 800-568-2790. Big Lou will answer your call and work to fit you into a term life policy that you can afford. Remember, Big Lou's like you. He's on meds too. Call 800-568-2790, 800-568-2790, or biglou.com.
You took the first step and quit smoking, but even former smokers may still be at risk for lung cancer. That's why SaveByTheScan.org wants you to know about a new low-dose CT scan that can detect lung cancer early. It takes only 60 seconds and could save your life. You took the first step, now take the next. Visit SaveByTheScan.org for a simple quiz to see if you're eligible and talk to your doctor about screening. SaveByTheScan.org is brought to you by the American Lung Association's Lung Force Initiative and the Ad Council.
Nothing slows my little girl down.
Except a stuffy nose.
Mommy.
That's why I use Sinex Children's Saline from Vicks. Sinex instantly clears mucus in everyday stuffy little noses with a gentle, ultra-fine mist designed for kids. Just Sinex? Breathe. Her stuffy nose is gone for now. And so is she.
Sinex Children's Saline. Sinex? Breathe. Use as directed. Keep out of reach of children.
It's the Mike McCarthy Show. Every Friday morning at 6:45 and 9 with R&R in the morning.
Do you like a certain amount of chaos?
Conflict is good. Yeah. Yes, I guess I do. You know, I like healthy chaos. I don't like the BS.
A look at the Cowboys' upcoming game presented by AA Best Bail Bonds and 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star.
It's R&R here on San Antonio Sports Star. Make sure you're liking and subscribing and sharing on the regular. Watch us live on our YouTube feed. That's the easiest way to reach out to us, too. You can contact us through that. Our 656-3776 is our utility number. Use that to talk or type or whatever you need to do. Do we have any giveaways today, Edwin?
No.
No giveaways.
We have no presents for post-Christmas for anybody?
Well, Christmas has already come.
Well, I know. Post-Christmas, though, it's now time for the deals, the steals and deals.
Well, I mean.
Gosh, I'm glad I'm not hitting the return lines today. And it's Saturday coming up.
Do you have to hit the return lines?
No, I have absolutely nothing to return.
That.
Do you?
Is a round of applause. No, nothing to return.
Used to it when I was heavier. I would always get stuff that was, you know,
you mean
I was
before the IFFH.
Yes, I would get things that were too small always. You know, I just, you know, people would buy a double X or whatever, and that just was never going to do it. So I was always the return guy. Or what has really happened is, as I've lost weight, this is one of those little benefits. Is all those things that I never returned that kind of just sat in the closet was still with the tags on. Now I'm like losing weight into, so it's like a little birthday gift, little Christmas in between. This, like, hey, this fits now. There's a lot of fantasy dudes that are dancing today as the Super Bowl. No, I'm not. Most of us are. The pretenders are always weeded out. if you were playing Amari Cooper this weekend, you're sad, and I was playing him. If you were playing against Puka Nacua,
put some respect. His name is former Dallas Cowboy Amari Cooper.
Not anymore. He is current Cleveland Brown and Joe Flacco hero. Amari, if you played Amari, you lost. If you played Puka Nacua, you lost. Breece Hall had him a day. Pickens had him a day. So surprises got some teams into their fantasy league Super Bowls. I, on the other, of course, was in two semifinals and lost them both. One of them, I woke up down by 100 points. I've never been. I lost one in a family league, but I'm not kidding. By like 140 points, I it was as bad a beatdown as I've ever seen. And three of those dudes I mentioned, I played against. Now I lost, but I knew it was over early. But there were some of us, at least one of us in this room, that had to wait to the bitter end to find out they lost. How much did you lose by last night, Jack?
0.78. One catch by George Kittle, and I'm going to the ship. But I am going to the ship in one league. So,
you know, the irony of this is I know that
I'm still get a dub.
Your loving partner, her favorite player is that guy.
One of them, yeah. She does indeed like George Kittle.
And aren't you going to have to play her in a fantasy league?
Yes, we will be playing in the ship.
I have never played my wife in any kind of competitive thing, ever.
Well, doesn't that spell disaster normally?
I don't know. I don't know what that's like. Because is there money at stake?
Yeah.
That's a little safety net.
A little bit.
It's just which account is it going in? Is that kind of it?
Well, I think second doesn't have to pay.
Oh, so either way, you all are golden.
Yeah.
Well, dance to the bank and enjoy this. It's kind of like
one way or another, we're getting the money.
How much were this? I know this is her first. Were you involved in her draft?
Dude. It's my second team.
That's what I thought. So
I'm playing against myself.
You know, the first time players always are good because everybody helps them.
Yeah, I've definitely helped her.
James, what did you take from the Texans this weekend?
They
took some profit and are going home.
No, I mean, it is a team that played. Been playing with house money all year for the most part, but it is a team that when the rest of the division also loses and you remain tied and everything's, they control their own destiny. You went out and you're playing the teams in front of you for the most part. You get the Titans this week, you finish with the Colts, and you control your own destiny for the division, the wild card, playoffs, all of it. So CJ Stroud is progressing through concussion protocol this week, it sounds like.
Uh-huh.
Could return.
Why? Why on earth do you want him playing again? What
if he's healthy, I don't care.
10 wins, baby.
Yeah, I mean, is there a bonus built in? Does he need to get some?
No. I mean, it's literally, you're either healthy and back from the concussion or you're not. That's why he didn't play.
No, I hide his helmet, though.
Why?
What's the point from here on out?
You've got a shot at the playoffs and the division.
Yeah, and that would be the sole and only thing. But I'm not risking the future on a couple of games here. What's your offensive line status?
It's the same as it's been all
year.
Yeah. It's the same that got you to 8-6.
You've won. Take your chips and go home.
Okay.
You've won.
Cowboys,
you've won.
You clinched a playoff spot. Take your chips
and
go.
We're going to talk about that, and I think that's kind of the situation the Cowboys find themselves in now.
I mean, it.
But right now, take your profits, Texans.
Absolutely not.
No. Well,
sacrifice.
There's no sacrifice. You either clear concussion protocol or you don't. There's no added risk if he's cleared it.
I think that the Texans have had a remarkably successful season.
Agreed.
That can only be marred by some sort of injury that would eat into next year. Because this is not a playoff win team. You're ahead of schedule. You didn't even expect to be here. So I play as if, but I do not risk CJ Stroud at all. If I lose one more, if I have any confidence.
So should the Texans cancel their remaining
two
games?
No, you play out with your old man. You chase some stats. You get guys some bonuses. And you get ready for a playoff run next year with a higher draft pick.
That is the A, they don't have their own draft pick, so it's irrelevant.
I'm not risking CJ Stroud for anything.
Soft.
What is risk? What do you mean risk?
That offensive line is terrible.
It's the same offensive line it's been all year.
Got him to 8-6. Okay. 8-7.
I look at this
dude's
as
in the league to play. He's in the play.
That's what I'm saying. I'm not saying he doesn't want to play, but I don't get I get that you need the experience, but I also go, if there is any risk to any of my future.
That's every time he plays. What I'm saying is
if that offensive line continues to look as bad as it does, what is the point? Because that Texans team got embarrassed at home against a team that understands how to win football games.
Well, it's not just that it understands. It was probably the best defensive line outside of Baltimore faced all year long.
And the line that I watched is not the line I want to put CJ Stroud behind in two games.
Dude, they've got the Titans and Colts. They're not going up against juggernauts here.
And they do. I would say if I'm okay, go chase it.
Why wouldn't you?
Okay.
Imagine they win out, get into the playoffs, mm-hmm. get a first-round win. That's huge.
It is huge.
That's huge for CJ.
But what I saw was a quarterback under distress all game. And you're right, they're playing against the best defense. Well, apart from what I witnessed last night. One of the best defenses in all of football and probably a top three in the AFC.
Mm-hmm.
It was a jailbreak, man.
It looks different, though, with...
Okay.
The reason I bring that up is,
or at least a smart quarterback that knows where to go with the football.
Well, I mean, this is still a rookie. What I witnessed was an offensive line that was an utter sieve. I mean, McCown was under whatever his name was under the old dude, was under attack all game long. Uh-huh. Nothing positive came out of that game. Nothing.
I've been watching that for 17 weeks.
Well, then what I'm getting at is...
There were only three sacks.
Yes, only three sacks. But you're going to tell me that he wasn't running for his life all night long.
No, he was.
It was. The offense was engineered to let these guys move around. There were some quick... What I'm getting at is the risk-reward here is something you've got to balance if you're the Texans. Well, because you've had a rookie quarterback that has progressed to his first year into second year experience already.
Most people come back from a concussion in 1 week, within the same week.
And
Trevor Lawrence was back from
Trevor
Sunday
Lawrence,
to
I
Saturday.
Think, suffers from Munchausen by proxy, man. That
but,
dude.
But my you, point
I've
is,
I've seen
all
him injured. Self-report an injury I never saw, and another injury that I thought he was going. It took him 3 hours to step off the field, and he's playing the next week. I know he's tough, but I think sometimes it's not quite as bad as he leads on.
That's
self-reported
saying,
a concussion. I know that you're mad at hearing this, but the Texans are so far ahead of schedule. I don't want to risk this quarterback for the future. That's the only thing I took away from that Texans Cleveland game is this team isn't even close. They're not a playoff caliber team. They got pantsed at home, and it wasn't just because they didn't have their quarterback. That there's really not a playoff win in this team. So all I'm looking at now is I'm judging for future. I'm looking at talent that I haven't had a chance to look at maybe. But I am not putting my quarterback at risk at all.
I mean, I see this team. You're telling me if they match up against the Chiefs, they don't have a chance in the playoffs?
The Chiefs are not the best opponent to judge.
But right they're an opponent you could possibly play. They're a division winner.
Yes. But if you think that the Chiefs are bad, but they're still far better than the Texans. Mm. Oh, come on. Don't fall asleep. You saw the Texans this week.
You saw the Chiefs this
week. Yeah, we've been talking about the Chiefs all week. But the Cleveland Browns rolled into Houston and pantsed them. And Kansas City would do the same.
What is it Greg Popovich always says? You don't skip steps. And part of the steps is learning to win in the playoffs. Getting to the playoffs is a big step. Even if you lose in the first round, that is a big step, especially for a bunch of rookies. Now, let's not forget, this is a team that was only without C.J. Stroud. They're without Jimmy Ward and Will Anderson Jr. and Jonathan Grenard. Like, they were without a Tank Dell. They were without a whole bunch of people. Yeah. It wasn't just C.J. Stroud. If those people start to come back and C.J.'s part of the people that come back, this is a team that has the makeup to not only win the division and possibly get a home game in the playoffs, but even if they're a wild card team, could get a favorable matchup against a team. Do you think the Dolphins are the most unbeatable team after what you saw against Dallas?
I think that the Dallas did a really good job against a very good offense. And that same defense that the Texans roll out will not do the same thing to Miami that the Cowboys did. And don't pretend that they could. They can't. That's a good team with the Texans. I'm not defaming. I'm saying take your profits and go home. You just listed five guys that you need for the future. And why rush a dude back now? All I'm saying. We'll talk silver and black, and you talk pop. You talk about steps that need to be taken. How far has it gone now that other teams' play-by-play guys are calling out the Spurs for one thing that they seem to refuse to do? We're going to talk about it coming up at 7 o'clock, the silver and black, as we do every day at 7. But coming back, maybe we need a belt, a trophy of some sort.
I think so.
But the first annual rib cook-off went down on Friday, brought to you by Yingling Flight by Yingling and all the good folks there. There was a winner, and it didn't, well, it was going away. We'll talk about that next. It's R&R, and you're on 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star.
94.1 San Antonio Sports Star.
At Mr. W Fireworks, we have always offered the lowest prices on fireworks.
And we always will.
We never charge additional hidden fees, and we price our fireworks more than 50% less than the other guys.
No joke.
When you shop at Mr. W Fireworks, you can be sure you are getting the lowest prices on fireworks around and the biggest selection.
Just look for the big W on our sign, and you are in the right place.
Visit MrWFireworks.com to find a location near you.
Mr. W Fireworks.
From our family to yours.
Happy New Year!
Injuries happen, and when they do, skip ER and get to the OrthoNow Injury Clinic by TSAOG Orthopedics and Spine. OrthoNow provides walk-in care for injuries like broken bones, dislocations, sprains, and strains. Conveniently located in the Cory area with extended hours Monday through Saturday with on-site x-ray casting and bracing, OrthoNow has everything you need to treat your injury, and best of all, no urgent care or emergency room copay. Learn more online at TSAOG.com.
The South Texas RV Super Sale is back at Freeman Expo Hall. And boy, do we have a great show this year. Hundreds of RVs, every shape and size. All dealers are ready to sell. You'll get the best prices of the year, January 4th through the 7th. South Texas RV SuperSale.com.
Our biggest clearance sale of the year is happening now at Blue Bonnet Chrysler Dodge Ram, the Wrap Up the Year sales event. Save 15% off MSRP on new Ram 1500 trucks. Wrap up some heavy duty savings. Take 12% off MSRP on all new Ram heavy duty trucks. Save $6,800 off MSRP on a new 2023 Dodge Charger SXT posted at only $28,995. Make no payments for 90 days. And remember,
at Blue Bonnet Prices, the difference.
Call 830-626-9799 for full price and offer details. Boost Mobile is giving families the holiday gift they really want. When you switch to Boost, get an iPhone 11 for only $49.99 or a free Samsung Galaxy A23. You'll get amazing service too, because only Boost switches between the top networks to give you the best service. So stop by a Boost Mobile store and give the gift of Boost. That's an iPhone 11 for $49.99 or a free Samsung Galaxy A23. Get yours at a Boost Mobile store today. Visit BoostMobile.com for details. New customers and in-store only. Requires auto pay and ID verification. Other restrictions apply. See participating dealers for details.
When you wake up well-rested on a great mattress, everything becomes clear.
I do have a favorite child.
Things you missed when you were tired finally reveal themselves.
I use memes as a coping mechanism.
It's Mattress Firm's once-a-year sale and clearance. Get up to 60% off select Sealy, plus a free adjustable base, all with free and fast delivery. Deals this big won't last long, so don't miss out. The right mattress matters. We'll find yours. Restrictions apply. See store or website for details.
If you have unfiled taxes or are in debt to the IRS, this is important news. The IRS just rolled out a new program to help struggling taxpayers more easily resolve their tax problems. It's called the Taxpayer Relief Initiative, and it opens up powerful new options for people looking to get back on the right track with the IRS. And no one knows this program like the professionals at Optima Tax Relief, America's most trusted tax resolution company. They've resolved over $1 billion in tax debt for their clients and have the expertise and experience to help you. One easy call to Optima can start the process, helping to put an end to your worries of wage garnishment, asset seizure, and other aggressive IRS actions. Make today the beginning of your fresh start with the IRS. Call the experts at Optima Tax Relief now for your free confidential consultation.
Call 800-714-8422. 800-714-8422. 800-714-8422.
Optima Tax Relief.
Some restrictions apply. For complete details, please visit OptimaTaxRelief.com.
El Guacamole and Mexican Grill is serving up your favorite Mexican dish. Visit them today at 25020 Blanco or call 210-499-5364 to place your order. Hot, fresh, made-to-order Mexican dishes. El Guacamole Mexican Grill.
Prescriptions require an online consultation with a healthcare provider who will determine if appropriate. Restrictions apply. See website for details and important safety information. Subscription required. Price varies based on product and subscription plan.
Hey guys, did you know there's a generic form of Viagra that works just the same, but is 95% cheaper? And you can get it online? Just go to hims.com/joy. Through Hims, you'll get a free medical consultation, discreet shipping if prescribed, a 100% online process, and trusted generic alternatives to the name brands. Add up to 95% off. That's right. Get generic for Viagra, the same active ingredient as brand name Viagra, but for 95% less. It's the same medication, still prescribed by a licensed medical provider, but with zero copay, no expensive appointments, and no awkward face-to-face conversations. To start your free online visit, you need to go to this exclusive address, hims.com/joy. That's hims.com/joy for your free online visit, hims.com/joy.
Good morning, everybody. Joe Reinagle here. I hope everybody had a great Christmas. We certainly did. It's going to be great to get back to react to all of the things that happened over the weekend, including that horrible loss to the Miami Dolphins. What is going on with the Dallas Cowboys? Shereen Williams will join us. That's coming up at 5:15. And Indy Kalu will talk about C.J. Stroud and when he's coming back when he joins us at 3:30. Hey, Rob. Clay. Hope you guys had a great Christmas.
We did.
Did you have a good one, champ?
The weekend started nice over at Minix's as he hosted the Sports Star Christmas gathering. It was a rib cook-off of sorts. I mean, a competition, an exhibition, we all ate good. But, yeah, the votes came in, and I won. I won. It was the bacon candy ribs that took it down.
Was it close?
No, I don't know. I didn't count the votes. I brined those ribs. That's the first time I'd ever done them.
Mm-hmm.
I brined the ribs, and it was a very strange cook.
So you found your pickle juice?
Well, I made my own brine. I never found the pickle juice, so I made my own with apple cider vinegar and beer and whatnot. But I had never brined a rib, and I brined them for about 12 hours before I started cooking them. So Friday, I got off air, got home as fast as I could, turned on the grill, and put them on. Now, I hadn't bought any new pellets, but I had enough by my, I know exactly how long my ribs normally take. And it's normally, if I've got them out of the refrigerator and, they're room temp, six hours and 30 minutes max.
Okay.
Well, I put those ribs on at 10:30. The blitz. It was 11, right at like 11:58. Or
I was like, you got home and must have thrown them immediately.
Well, I was out the door. I knew I had a cook to do, and I knew that I was expected over at the Minix Casa. They got off air about 6, so I knew that there would be people there and they'd be ready to eat.
Mm-hmm.
So put them on at 11 o'clock with expectation at worst case scenario at 5:30 they'd be done. I'm not that far away from Minix's. I can get in a car and drive over.
Mm-hmm.
5:30. I'm at my ribs are now only at about 180, 185.
Didn't get up to temp fast enough.
I think it was the liquid in the meat.
Okay.
So that turned into what was essentially like a 7 hour and 15 minute cook. So those things got low and slow cooked to where that meat was butter.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it was an outrage. They were really good ribs. But what I did when I arrived, I did something inadvertently, and I'm not going to take blame for something I didn't do, though I did play a role in a destruction of something that Joe did that I'm still embarrassed.
The tri-tip?
I'll tell you about it on the other side. Hey, we're talking silver and black as the Spurs went down yet again. The street sits at 4. Can they do it again? They got Utah tonight. We're talking silver and black next. This is R&R, and you're on 94.1. San Antonio's Sports Star.
It's Dallas Cowboys football on 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star. This Saturday, the Cowboys welcome the Motor City Kitties to the Big D. It's a football beauty. Saturday night, Cowboys and Lions at 6:30.
Micah Parsons is on the ball.
And he's still alive.
He's still running to the goal line.
Presented by AA Best Bail Bonds, the Law Office of Jesse Hernandez, the Texas Chunk Law, Ewald Kubota, Mother's Window Tint, Woods Comfort Systems, and 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star.
The hustle and bustle of Christmas is over, and it's time to treat myself for all of my hard work. So, of course, I went to Kohl's. And boy, I'm glad I did, because it's their biggest clearance event of the season. I saved 70% on a cute pair of jeans, a cozy sweater, and some comfy PJs. Yep, going to Kohl's was just what I needed. Now to get back in the holiday spirit for New Year's. Select styles. Up to 70% offer ends January 21st. Some exclusions apply. See store or Kohl's.com for details.
If you or someone you know is having thoughts of suicide or experiencing a mental health or substance use crisis, 988 provides 24/7 compassionate support and connection to trained counselors. When you call, text, or chat 988, you'll be quickly connected to trained counselors who will listen to your concerns, provide support, and connect you to additional resources if needed. There is hope. The Lifeline works. You are not alone. For 24/7 support, just call, text, or chat 988.
There's never any FOMO with the iHeartRadio app. You won't ever have to miss out on your favorite shows and contests with this radio station again. Radio 24/7, 365. We're here when you want us. Stay connected and listen anywhere when you download the free iHeartRadio app.
As the weather gets colder, the NFL offers Stay Hot on FanDuel. Right now, new customers get $150 in bonus bets with any winning $5 moneyline bet. That's $150 if your team wins. If you've been thinking about joining FanDuel, there's no better time to get in on the action. The app is so easy to use. There's a wide range of betting options, spreads, player props, over-unders, and more. So visit FanDuel.com/win. FanDuel, official partner of the NFL.
Must be 21 plus and present in state. We're offered a wager. FanDuel is offering online sports wagering in Kansas under an agreement with Kansas Star Casino LLC. First online real money wager, only $5 pregame money line wager required. First online real money wager, only $10 first deposit required. Bonus issued is non-withdrawable bonus bets that expire 7 days after receipt. See terms at sportsbook.fanduel.com. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-GAMBLER or visit FanDuel.com/RG in Colorado, Iowa, Michigan, New Jersey, Ohio, Pennsylvania, Illinois, Kentucky, Tennessee, and Virginia. Call 1-800-NEXT-STEP or text NEXT-STEP to 53342 in Arizona, 1-888-789-7777 or visit ccpg.org/chat in Connecticut. 1-800-9-WITH-IT in Indiana, 1-800-522-4700. Visit ksgamblinghelp.com in Kansas, 1-877-770-STOP in Louisiana. Visit mdgamblinghelp.org in Maryland. Visit 1-800-GAMBLER.net in West Virginia or call 1-800-522-4700 in Wyoming. Help is here. Visit gamblinghelpma.org or call 1-800-327-5050 for 24/7 support in Massachusetts or call 1-877-8-HOPE-NY or text HOPE-NY in New York.
Happy holidays from your neighbors at El Guacamole Mexican Grill. Place your breakfast or lunch order today. Visit them at 25020 Blanco or call 210-499-5364. Hot, fresh, made-to-order Mexican dishes. El Guacamole Mexican Grill.
It's the Southern Recipe Small Batch Pork Rind Appreciation Day Celebration. Enter to win $5,000 cash, tailgating prizes, plus Southern Recipe Small Batch Pork Rinds when you pass the pigskin. Enter at PorkRindAppreciationDay.com. That's PorkRindAppreciationDay.com. And make sure to pick up the protein pack, bold flavors of Southern Recipe Small Batch Pork Rinds today at HEB.
America's best high school football players are coming to San Antonio. It's the All-American Bowl at the Alamo Dome on Saturday, January 6th. Trevor Lawrence, Christian McCaffrey, and Micah Parsons played here. Join us for a day of exciting football to see the stars of tomorrow at the All-American Bowl, followed by the San Antonio Sports All-Star Football Game, presented by Valero. Tickets are on sale at the Dome box office and Ticketmaster.
Hey, poker players, the Big Blind is opening early January, 281 in Redland Road, just down from the Rue Pub. The Big Blind will be the premier poker room in San Antonio, featuring an upscale environment catering to players from all abilities, from daily cash games to daily, weekly, and monthly tournaments. Opening in early January, the Big Blind is hiring dealers, hosts, and servers. Apply in person weekdays from 10 to 5 at the Big Blind, 281 and Redland Road.
America's Diamond has never sold lab-grown diamonds, and we warned our clients, friends, and neighbors that wholesale prices would crash to almost nothing. 2-carat GVS2 lab-grown diamonds are currently being traded at wholesale for $264, but some jewelers are still selling them online for $3,000 to $4,000. Repeat, wholesale $264, retail $3,000 to $4,000. Some retailers are selling 1-carat lab-grown diamonds for under $300, and others are giving them away for free with purchase. Lab-grown diamonds are very easy to detect with gemological equipment. Tens of millions of carats are produced in huge factories in China and India, using a tremendous amount of subsidized electricity supplied by coal-burning power plants. America's Diamond has only offered traditional, real, natural earth-grown diamonds that are rare, extremely beautiful, and have had real value for centuries. See our television program tonight on ABC KSAT 12 at 12:35 a.m. or right now at americasdiamond.com.
This is Jim Rome. Have a take, don't suck. On 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star, KTFM Floresville.
San Antonio's Sports Center.
Texas Longhorns landed former UTSA and Smith Valley outside linebacker and the AAC Defensive Player of the Year, Trey Moore, who entered the portal at the end of the year. They did lose backup quarterback Malik Murphy as a transfer, though, as he's going to Duke. The Texas State Bobcats are in action tonight as they take on Rice in the ServPro First Responder Bowl, kickoff set for 4:30. Talking Silver and Black next.
SportsCenter is brought to you by Byers Barricades, the Texas authority in barricade rental. ByersBarricades.com.
It's 0600. What's the O stand for? Oh my God, it's early.
Wake me up. Wake me up. Wake up. Wake up. Wake me up.
Rob Thompson.
Ginobili the other way in transition to the back with a left-hand slam.
I want some nasty.
Rudy J.
Cowboys win. How else would you settle this game?
Begin each day as if it were on purpose.
I wake up in the morning, I'm just excellent.
R&R in the morning on 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star.
Good morning.
Good morning to you. It's R&R in the morning, a Tuesday edition. Get up and get going. Don't mind them brake lights. We'll get you where you're going. I'm Rob Thompson. No Rudy J today. Eazy-E driving this boat, but we are host to the former and ongoing
permanent crew for the Saturday morning hangover. It's retired. Is it done? I don't know. It's on hiatus as we sit right now, but the Saturday morning hangover crew. And, of course, James Pledger, the host of Extra Innings Every Day. James Pledger, Jack Thompson, other co-hosts.
Stop telling people to get up and get out the door and move it, man.
For some of us.
They don't have to.
Some do. Not.
Stay in bed.
I wish I did. And if you are, we're glad you're watching us on your device. And if you're not, you need to be. YouTube feed, San Antonio Sports Star, R&R in particular. Watch us live there. Make sure you're subscribing, liking on the daily, and telling your friends about it. We do it every day at 7 o'clock. It's the Silver and Black podcast. We talk about the Spurs and where they sit, and there hadn't been a whole lot of shift. We saw the Spurs lose a 3-game roadie, take one in the teeth when in Chicago, then show up in Dallas, I guess, for a minute or two, and watch the Mavs run away. We saw Jokic get his, 10,000th point? He's now, 8th all-time scorer in Mavericks history in, 3-4 years, it seems like. And the Spurs lose yet again. No Wimby. He hurt his ankle in warmups. He only played 10 minutes in Chicago.
Yeah.
Not a busy roadie for Wimby. And yet again, another outing that was, I don't know. They are as bad as we think they are, and then they get worse.
Yeah. It's extremely tough to watch. Tough to watch is an understatement when you talk about the San Antonio Spurs. They were supposed to be better.
Did we have the sound from the play-by-play guy from Chicago? Edwin, do we have listen, it's one thing to be a Spur fan and watch them every day and see the tendencies and see what the Spurs are doing. And we know whether it be by design or by omission,
it has to be
the Spurs design. Do not throw the ball to Wimby. And if Wimby does get it,
11 win focus is really just
if he does get it, he passes it up. But it is now becoming apparent, and it's being talked about around the rest of the league, you've got this 7-5 next. You've got the future, but you refuse to give him the ball. This is play-by-play guy from the Chicago Bulls.
Brandon missed him too.
I don't know how you miss a 7-4 guy.
Yeah, how do you exactly not don't see understand him in your field of vision there?
Like, he's yelling, throw the ball up to the rim. Remember, he hurt the Bulls in San Antonio by just throwing it up there, and they wouldn't go get it. Man, it's almost like his team is reluctant to throw it to him. Wembanyama is your number one guy, and everyone else needs to find their role after that. Because it seems like right now, just from watching this team twice now, is that there's guys out here trying to figure out if I'm the number one guy.
Yes.
Am I the number one guy? No, I hate to break it to you. You're not. You're not.
That was the opponent telling us how to play better. Yep. That was the team that has now seen the Spurs for the season. They're not going to see them again. They've watched them play twice. And the takeaway was, you're not giving Wemby the ball. We've been saying it. Now, Jack, you just said it. It has to be by design, right?
It literally has to be. I cannot understand how Wemby is missed so often, cutting through the lane, backdoor lobs, pick and pop, what you name it. It's every game. There's at least five wide open passes that are missed to Wemby.
Judging by your CJ Stroud comment, we should just shut Wemby down for the rest of the year. I mean, he tweaked his ankle. You don't want to risk the future.
Your Texan is waving.
It is. But, I mean, what's the point in doing this willfully where you're keeping the ball out of his hands purposefully? Like, what's the point of if that is willful? Like, that's where I'm having the tough time. I don't think it's willful, except possibly by the players, not by design. Like, they
that's
want
our point, I think, James. I think. Are we looking at a selfish group of young guys refusing to give up what is imminent?
Yeah.
Refusing to accept the fact no matter how good you get,
you ain't staying around.
You ain't going to be number one dude. Devin, no matter how good you get, whether you get all-star votes this year, whether you get whatever comes your way, you will never be the dog. You'll never be the number one option. Keldon, no matter how much you do, no matter how much you try, no matter how much you hustle and play big body, you will never be the guy, ever, as long as Wemby is here. No. And do you get the sense they're going to try to prove to coach or themselves or to whoever might be trading for them when they imminently get traded that I'm capable of this? Because this is by design, either by the coach saying, we're going to spring this on them when they least expect it, which that makes no sense, or it's the players refusing to admit what is imminent.
I think it's these guys know that they're not necessarily long for the team. So
every game's a tryout.
Why the hell? Why does it matter what I do? Like, why should I pass to Wemby? I'm going to go and try and get mine and look better for a team who might want me.
Because it certainly isn't about wins and losses. It certainly isn't like they're attacking the game like we need the win to prove to ourselves that this is working, because that's not the case. We're not winning despite Wemby not touching it. We're getting hosed. And even when he's not there, when you have the green light, it looks even worse, which it should.
This is how bad teams stay bad.
Yeah.
This is the issue when egos and selfishness get in the way. Because, look, we've said it before. Even a bad team has a 20-point-a-night score. Doesn't mean you're a good player that can carry a team.
Yeah.
And so this is how, A, bad habits get formed and how you turn in from a dynasty like the Spurs were, who are just churning in year out, year out, into the Pistons, who are perennially.
We look so much like the Rockets did a couple years ago. Just no
undisciplined.
Extremely undisciplined, taking nothing but really tough shots, not sharing the ball, lazy rotations, bad boxing out. Like, we just look like a team that is just going out there and playing like there's no game plan.
And how'd the Rockets fix that?
They kept drafting. And then they finally got a serious point guard to come in and get these young guys in order and brought in a coach that will wrangle them in the same way.
New coach and veterans. It wasn't just the point guard. They added a bunch of veterans this offseason.
But I think that Van Vliet
was with the point guard.
Was the seminal and most important thing they did in the offseason.
I said it during the offseason that Fred would have been absolutely perfect for this team because he knows his role. He's never been the top dog. He took a backseat to Kawhi. He went and got a ship. He knows how to run the ship. Like he was the perfect addition for the Rockets. And
okay, so if we're looking at the progression of the team, do you expect that at the very least, if that's the next thing, that they are going to go find a point guard, whether it be of age or of experience or in a draft, whatever the case is, that you have to go through something like this? You just said the Rockets looked like this. Do you have to go through this?
I mean,
no.
You have to, you have to go through the losing, but it's the lack of like discipline, and the culture just looks so bad for the Spurs right now. That's what you, that's how you stay bad.
That's how bad habits
building bad habits. And that's what we're looking like we're doing right now. That's how you stay bad. That's why the Pistons are so bad. Look, they have
Wizards.
You look at the Pistons, they literally, I'm pretty sure they have 10 like lottery picks on that team alone. Like 10.
Killian Hayes, Cade Cunningham,
Jalen Duren,
Wiseman.
Like they have 10.
But they changed coaches. They did change coaches. They did what you're talking about, and that didn't help. They got worse.
Out of all the people we named, notice what we didn't name. Veterans.
Yeah.
They also don't have veterans. Young kids don't know how to lead young kids. You need somebody who's been in the league, who can take ownership, who can teach them, and not just like comes to the gym every third Tuesday.
And most importantly, that veteran has to be your starting point guard. Like that is the leader of the team. Look at every team that has won a championship over the past probably 10 years that didn't have LeBron. That's it. They had a great veteran guard. Even Jokic, even Giannis needed it.
Yeah.
Jamal Murray and Drew Holiday were essential to those teams.
I remember we talked about it after the draft. I was like, once Dame Lillard got traded, I was like, well, Drew Holiday's not long for Portland. Go get Drew Holiday. He's the guard you need with Wimby.
Is that the last piece or the middle piece?
That's the first piece you need.
It's the most important.
But the problem with that is
gas.
You're
going
to have to trade for that.
Yeah.
So?
Well, I agree. I agree. Because no free agent is going to come to a team that you tell them, look, we're going to pay a fair amount of money, but it's going to be a while before we're winning.
No, you've got to trade for it. And you have to. It's so valuable that overpaying is, you got to do it. Like, you got to go get a cornerstone at point guard. You cannot win without it. You cannot.
You've got all this draft capital. Use it. Like, you have it for a reason.
Yeah.
The Thunder did it. They went and got Shai Gilgeous-Alexander.
So, given their inability or this willful inattention to Wimby, is it because they don't have the guys that can get it to him? Is it, are we going back to the idea that this will never happen, not because it's attitude, we're going to figure it out, but Jeremy Sohan, Blake Wesley, Malachi Brennan, Trey Jones, whatever combination we throw out there, it's just not going to happen because they just don't have the skill set? Or how hard is it to throw the ball at Wimby, who's 7'5", just
not
throw it
hard? It's literally not hard.
I want you to listen to what Devin Vassell said after their loss to the Bulls. This is the most important thing and why they need a veteran leader at the point guard position.
I think just being a team, being a young team, we got to be able to know each other's strengths. You know what I'm saying? I mean, Wimby at 7'5", we got to see him. You know, when he's down there, and whether he's posting up or if he's sealing early, we got to see him. You know, if Jeremy's posting a smaller guard, we got to know that that's a mismatch. We got to know that we could get it to him. Like, if I'm open at the three-point line, if I'm open sometimes, like, we just got to get it there. Like, we got to just be able to play to each other's strengths. I feel like sometimes we might dribble one or two more times, and now instead of Wimby being open on a lob, now they crack down to him, and now he's not open. Or if we over-dribble it, now I'm not open on the three, or whatever the case may be, and now instead of it being a good shot, it's a contested shot, and now it's a long rebound. We're trying to get back on transition, and it just trickles down from there. So I feel like at the end of the day, we just really got to understand each other. Like, we got to understand. I mean, we done played 20 something games now. I feel like we should have more and a better understanding. And it's on all of us, and we just got to be better.
That right there, that's it right there. We're dribbling too much. Like, we dribble 2 to 3 extra times. Like, this is the epitome of a team that is filled with guys that are looking to get theirs.
Dude, that was him begging for a point guard. That was him telling his coach, telling the world, I got a point guard in Jeremy Sochan who doesn't know what he's doing.
He's not a point guard.
Who doesn't know. He's over dribbling. He doesn't look where the ball should go until he has taken the required steps to get to the point. It's those little things that go from learning how to be one and being one. And he ain't. And he's not anywhere near gonna be one. And Devin is screaming like, look, dude, somebody has to figure out. He didn't say just to Wimby. He said to him, too, sometimes they over-dribble, they miss me on a three. He is pointing to point guard play. That's what he's saying.
He also said we're over-dribbling and we're missing a mismatch down low.
Talking about Jeremy.
No, but he said missing Jeremy down low. Threes. Sure, they're all missing everyone.
What I'm saying is, even at his best, Devin is second option.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Even at the very best he'll ever get. So if we're missing the first option and then we're missing the second option, that goes directly to the point guard play. He is begging for it. He is the second. He is not initiating this.
It's not just him, though. I think it's Keldon.
Him. It is him telling everybody, this is Keldon's fault. This is Sohan's fault.
Yes.
It is not as much Devin's fault.
No.
It is not.
No, Devin is told to, every time you get to a spot, shoot it.
He's got his job to do, and he's doing it as well as he can, given the situation. He's begging for it. He's telling his coach. He's telling his fans. Yeah. Look, we got a problem, and it starts with the initiation. And at best, I know that I'm supposed to throw it to Wimby. I'm saying that if I had it and I have the opportunity, I will. It's you. It's you. And you are not doing it. And I'm tired of the coach telling us. I'm trying to convince us that it's going to work. And if he's trying to convince us, you better go convince the fans, because now they're taking it out on us. Did you see Sochan tweet yesterday about being attacked on Christmas? This is getting personal with these guys, because Pop has put his kids in positions to be unsuccessful. I mean, at the very least, I want my coach to put me in a situation where I feel like I can bloom and flower and grow as a player. Jeremy Sochan is a lesser player today than he was when the season began. We have taken a potential star for a variety of reasons and put him in a situation where he cannot and will not be successful.
The problem is, they've built this bed. They've made it. There's no fix to it immediately. You can't do anything.
We're loaded with draft picks. Loaded. Loaded. We got plenty of stuff to deal with.
And the trade deadline just opened, what, 10 days ago? The 15th was when
people could. We have until February the
9th. You have until. But most people aren't looking to unload assets this early.
Oh, we are.
No, I'm talking about if you're looking to acquire and fix this situation without a point. That's what I'm saying.
No,
there's no fix right now.
That's what Devin is saying. Like, right now, man, until we figure it out, and I don't see the fix until there's a consistent point guard play. And we know that at the very minimum, they do have one in Trey Jones, but the consistent refusal, and it's now a refusal from Pop to put him in the starting lineup, is a disgrace. And I hear Devin screaming for it. Please get somebody in who understands it. I'm not saying Trey Jones is on the top of the list and understanding how to play with 7'5 Wimby, but at least he's closer than everybody else on that court.
He's far and ahead close.
Aren't they trying to fix it though with Malachi Branham in the starting lineup?
No. Malachi and
I understand he's not a point guard, but aren't they trying to lessen how much Jeremy Sohan's in control by putting Malachi in the starting lineup? Yeah. I mean,
but last game against the Mavericks, we started two guys that wouldn't start on basically any other team in the league in Malachi and Julian. Like, if this, there's a lot going on with the Spurs, but the orchestrated tank is still happening.
Without question.
Without for what?
Another number one.
Is Topich that?
No, it's about the pick. It's not about the player.
The orchestrated tank is absolutely still at play because there's literally no reason why Trey Jones should not start at point guard. There's literally no reason why Devontae Graham should gets no minutes a game when he's probably our second best guard on the whole team.
Oh, he's absolutely the second best point guard on the team.
There's like,
it's not saying much, but yeah, I agree.
It's orchestrated tank is still at play. And the only reason I could think is because of how valuable a top five pick is on the trade market.
That's the only chase. This is the Silver and Black Podcast. We do it every day at 7 o'clock. Make sure you're liking, subscribing, and sharing. Tell a friend. Tomorrow we'll do it again at 7 o'clock as we will look back at a Utah Jazz game tonight as the Spurs welcome in the Jars to the Frost Center tonight.
Clarkson, baby.
Yeah, coming on home. We get to see a little bit of that upstart Utah team. Hey, coming up, let's talk with an expert. We watched the Dallas Cowboys go to sunny Miami, and well, we saw the outcome. Clarence Hill Jr., the Fort Worth Star-Telegram, will join us next as we look back to a loss and look forward to the Detroit Lions. We got Cowboy Talk coming. This is R&R. You're on 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star. I hope you woke up this morning and washed yourself clean underneath the Connecticut water, soft and shower. If you did, congratulations. You made a fine decision. You made a decision the likes of which you're not going to have to worry about for a long, long time. You see, when you get a Connecticut, it's the last water softener you're ever going to own. They say it. I believe it. Talk to your neighbors. Talk to your friends. I bet they've got a Connecticut. I've had one for a long time. No worries at all. I don't have to worry about that white stuff on my dishes when I pull them out of the dishwasher. My hair doesn't get all dry and my skin isn't all flaky, and I'm not worried about what I'm drinking. I'm on a well. That matters even more to have a water purification system the likes of what Connecticut can offer. If you're using the aquifer or living over the well, a water softener saves your pipes, saves you money. And right now, if you want to save a lot of money, how about calling Connecticut at 656-PURE, 656-PURE. They'll come out and put a water softener in your home for 90 days without a penny. No commitment, no ask. They want to prove it to you. They want to find out what all of us already know, that Connecticut's the water softener for you. Call them. They'll come out and put one in, and in 90 days, you'll be just like us, a Connecticut customer for life. They say it, I believe it. It's the last water softener you ever want to own. Go to ConnecticutSA.com for all your details, but start the new year right with a Connecticut in your house. Call them today and thank me later.
It's the Blitz with Jason and Joe. Afternoons at 2.
Coming up on the Blitz, boy, I hope everybody had a great Christmas. It was a wonderful Christmas for our family. It's good to be back. We're going to react to all of the things that happened over the weekend. Plus, we're going to get you ready for the college football playoffs. C.J. Stroud didn't play. When's he coming back? Well, Indy Kalu may have some answers for us when he joins us at 3:30.
The Blitz with Jason and Joe. Afternoons at 2. On 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star.
Life moves fast. No one has time for a car, truck wreck, or commercial vehicle accident. At Davis Law Firm, we get it. When you call the force, you don't have to worry about insulting offers from insurance adjusters, property damage, or car rental. We recently settled a wrongful death case in a commercial vehicle accident for $5 million. Net to clients was $2.8 million. I'm Jeff Davis. If you were in a car, truck wreck, or hit by a commercial vehicle, call me at 444-4444. You got it. There's only one number to remember. 4. Attorney consultation by appointment only. Davis Law Firm, San Antonio. Davis Law Firm is a proud official partner, personal injury attorney of the San Antonio Spurs.
Listen to this station anytime, anywhere on Odyssey. Odyssey is your new audio home for all the music, news, sports, and podcasts that matter to you. Odyssey, that's AUDACY.
I have diabetes. I'm at risk for pneumococcal pneumonia.
I have asthma. I'm at risk too.
If you're 19 or older with chronic conditions like asthma, diabetes, COPD, or heart disease, or are 65 or older, you are at increased risk for pneumococcal pneumonia. Ask your doctor or pharmacist about Prevnar 20, pneumococcal 20-valent conjugate vaccine, a Pfizer vaccine that can help protect you against pneumococcal pneumonia in just one dose. Even if you've already been vaccinated with other pneumonia vaccines, Prevnar 20 may help provide added protection. Prevnar 20 is approved for adults to help prevent infections from 20 strains of the bacteria that cause pneumococcal pneumonia. Continued approval may depend on a supportive study. Don't get Prevnar 20 if you've had a severe allergic reaction to the vaccine or its ingredients. Adults with weakened immune systems may have a lower response to the vaccine. Side effects include pain and swelling at the injection site, fatigue, headache, muscle, and joint pain. For full prescribing information, please call 1-855-213-2138 or visit Prevnar20.com.
Finding great candidates to hire can be like, well, trying to find a needle in a haystack. Sure, you can post your job to some job board, but then all you can do is hope the right person comes along, which is why you should try ZipRecruiter for free at ZipRecruiter.com/free. ZipRecruiter doesn't depend on candidates finding you. Its powerful technology identifies people with the right experience and actively invites them to apply to your job. You get qualified candidates fast. So while other companies might deliver a lot of hay, ZipRecruiter finds you what you're looking for. The needle in the haystack.
4 out of 5 employers who post a job on ZipRecruiter get a quality candidate through the site within the first day. ZipRecruiter, the smartest way to hire. And right now you can try ZipRecruiter for free. That's right, free. Just go to this exclusive web address, ziprecruiter.com/free. That's ziprecruiter.com/free. ZipRecruiter.com/free.
At the YMCA of Greater San Antonio, you'll find the tools and support system you need to become the healthiest you in spirit, mind, and body. Find your true self and join today at YMCASATX.org. Find your why this year at YMCA San Antonio. Happy New Year.
Joe, I've invented the perfect exercise machine. It's practical, efficient, and fits in any home. I give you the Row and Go. It's a rowing machine that connects to your toilet, so you can row and...
Stop. Folks, at Quarter Moon Plumbing, Heat, and AC, we help homes stay in tip-top shape. Call Quarter Moon, 651-5899.
Quarter Moon Plumbing, Heat, and AC, 210-651-5899.
License number M16004, DACLA 000743458.
It is time to play Pass the Pigskin. Great chance to win $5,000 cash and tailgate prize packs. Celebrate with Southern Recipe Small Batch Pork Rinds by entering the Pork Rind Appreciation Day giveaway at porkrindappreciationday.com. That's porkrindappreciationday.com. And don't forget to pick up your favorite bold-flavored protein-packed Southern Recipe Small Batch Pork Rinds today at HEB.
It's the Awesome Tickets Pro Football Pick'em Challenge on 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star. You're shot at $50,000 nationally, while weekly winners locally get a $50 gift card to Five Oaks Ace Hardware on Thousand Oaks. At the end of the season, locally, the best overall record wins the San Antonio grand prize of $1,000 worth of tickets to any event from Awesome Tickets. Sign up today at sasportsstar.com.
R&R in the morning on 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star.
Good morning to you. It's R&R in the morning here on San Antonio Sports Star. Rudy J in the hole today. He'll be back tomorrow. He's celebrating with friends and fam. But if you're celebrating a Dallas Cowboys loss, you're in the right place. For I don't know if it's a celebration. Let's talk about it. We've invited in the experts and the first to arrive. And the very favorite one, that's Clarence Hill Jr. of the Fort Worth Star-Telegram. Merry Christmas to you, sir. Happy holidays and good morning to you.
Thank you, man. Merry Christmas to you. And how are you doing this wonderful Tuesday morning?
Well, it doesn't feel like Tuesday, does it? But it is a time to attack the week. You know, coming out of Miami, this was one of those games where a lot of good could come from it and not a lot of bad unless you walked out of there hurt. They go down late, but Dak closed out with a drive. What was the general consensus of the team? Was it one that got away that they felt like they should have gotten, or was it a worthy account of themselves against a very good football team on the road?
Yeah, you know, it was curious, man, because the Cowboys felt like they acquitted themselves well. They held their heads high, especially after the way they lost in Buffalo. And they're looking at it as, I don't know, they won't say moral victory, but they say there was a lot of good that come out of that they can build on for the future. To me, that's a moral victory, because at the end of the day, you continue to lose on the road. At the end of the day, there are things you did that prevented you from winning, which you could tenderly do on the road. But no, you didn't get your doors blown off like you did in San Francisco. Didn't get your doors blown off like you did in Buffalo. Dak did come up with a gutsy drive, and you got to give Dak all the credit in the world, that offense all the credit in the world for coming up with that gutsy drive to put the Cowboys in the lead. After they were down by 9 in the fourth quarter, 2 scores in the fourth quarter, they came back and took the lead. But when you needed it the most, defense couldn't get a stop. So I don't know how you look at it. Certainly they feel that penalties, that face mask, you know, on Clark, which the Cowboys continually, they lead the league in penalties. They continue to be their own worst enemy come to penalties, that kills drives and prevents them from winning on the road, that fumble on the opening drive of the game. And I don't know, you know, the fumble was awful. But Tony Pollard not getting in on the play before was, to me, worse. How do you not? I mean, we've talked about not having the hammer at the goal line, and I guess they were trying to make the rookie fullback their hammer. But, you know, Tony not getting in on it would look like a wide open touchdown to the edge, and him getting stopped at the one. How do you not get in there?
Well, he got his butt in. He got his butt in. He just couldn't get the football in.
But not the ball, right?
You know, given what we saw, and, you know, they attempted, like you said, of using Lepke as the hammer down there. And you brought up something else, the penalties. And that's the last bastion of losers, to blame penalties. But I'm not blaming penalties on the loss, but it is two consecutive weeks where there have been remarkably questionable calls, or lack thereof, in games that really changed the game, and plays that really did change the game. And it's your fault, my fault, nobody's fault. And a lot of it is just bad luck. But at some point, the penalties, whether it's their fault or not, it has to be addressed. This is going to be the problem of the year if they don't address it. Am I wrong here?
There's no question about it. And there's so many Cowboy fans, and the Cowboys complained about not getting holes on Micah Parsons. And, you know, whether that was a questionable rough of the passer penalty, you know. But yeah, but T.J. Watt is saying the same thing. You know, they're saying the same thing in Cleveland. You know, it's a problem. You know, and it's a huge problem because Micah's their best player, and their plays, you know, you think are game changing holes are not being called. But again, the false starts, the offsides, the illegal shifts down there. Just it's too many times the Cowboys are doing it to themselves. The holes on Tyler Smith on offense, there's always somebody doing something bad at the wrong time, and it's really themselves. They cut out their own penalties. They don't have to worry about the lack of the holes on Micah Parsons. But it's always something for the Cowboys.
It's always something for the Cowboys, but it seems to be narratives. And are those narratives starting to work their way into the psyche of the Cowboys? The inability to win on grass, the inability to win on the road, the not being finished drives like they did early in the game. I mean, this game felt kind of a mirror image of what happened in Philadelphia, to where it was self-inflicted wounds in a lot of instances that kept them from winning this game.
And I'm glad you brought up Philadelphia, because Philadelphia was a game which the Cowboys lost. They beat themselves, but they used it as an example of, yeah, we lost, but we're playing well. You know, we lost, but we played well enough to win the game. And that was true. And it wasn't like, again, that was they had won. That was part of a stretch of when they won 7 of 8 games. Mm-hmm. And Philadelphia loss was not a setback. You know, it was another example of offense taking a step forward. And that's how the Cowboys were looking at this. You know, just in the locker room, we talked to everybody, and Mike McCarthy, yeah, we got to win the road, we got to win the playoffs, but we can take some good out of this. And the same thing with Dak. We can take some good. Like, they felt good about how they played. You know, and if the Philadelphia game is an example, then they should feel good about how they played, because it was part of a run. But at the end of the day, as I started out from, you know, you are what your record says you are, you know, and you again lost your fifth game on the road, you know, and you still have yet to be a team with a winning record on the road, grass, turf, whatever, you know, and those are the issues, and those are things that, based on what you've done, you're going to have to be road warriors in the playoffs. And can you do it when it matters most? Now, you can say you're taking positive things about it, but until you do it, you haven't done it. And you're going to have to go in the playoffs without anything in your memory bank of winning against a winning team on the road.
You know, Clarence, as we head in two more games, they're locked in, as we said, it appears, in that fifth slot. We watch what Philadelphia damn near did yesterday with the new butt fumble.
Let me just say this. Nothing the Cowboys did in Miami hurts them from winning the division, because all Philadelphia has to do is drop one game,
right,
and the Cowboys went out, they win the division.
So how much of that played into the mindset going into Miami?
I doubt it. No, they know they had to win. They wanted to win because of what happened in Buffalo. There was not a mindset of we don't need this game. I don't, Cowboys really not one to be looking at scenarios and saying the Philadelphia, the Miami game didn't matter because the only thing that matters is the conference and division games, and the Philadelphia drops the conference or division game, and we went out, we're in. That was not part of their mindset, but those are the reality. That is the reality. You know, if you know, and Philadelphia showed you again that there's something amiss about that team, and the Giants came back and damn near won that game. And so they have the Giants, you know, I don't know what's going on with the Cardinals. They have the Cardinals, and then they have the Giants at the end of the season. So it's not a guarantee that Philadelphia is going to go through unscathed, especially with a road game at the Giants at the end of the season. The Giants are still trying to play for something. Because if that game yesterday was in New York and not Philadelphia, Philadelphia may have lost that game, and the Cowboys would be back in the Cadbury seat with opportunity to win the division. So it's all there. But, again, now they're facing Detroit, which is not going to be an easy game. You know, they're at home and they win at home, but don't assume just because they're home they're going to beat Detroit, because Detroit's a very good team.
I'm glad you brought up Detroit and the fact that that game's at home, because I look at this game as a real opportunity for them to possibly lose three straight, with one of the flaws of the Cowboys being late in games, being able to stop the run when teams are openly trying to shove it down their throat. We saw it in Buffalo. We saw it late in that Miami game. Detroit wants to be physical and run the football, and the lack of a linebacking presence seems to be an issue for the Cowboys when teams vehemently want to run the ball against them.
Yeah, I mean, stopping the run has been, you know, the question since training camp. You know, they've all talked about it. They got better stop the run, and you know, they weren't. It didn't raise its ugly head at times, you know, for much of the season, because they had been playing so well in the offense, getting out the early leads and scoring so much. Other teams couldn't just pound the ball. When a team's able to pound the ball, it's a close game, that's when it's a problem. So, again, which Cowboys tried to do against Miami, they took the ball and you know, tried to score, set the tone offensively. This Detroit defense can be had. They have to set the tone offensively to help that defense out. They can score points on the Detroit defense now. Well, you know, the big question for the Cowboys is Tyron Smith. You know, you saw when Tyron Smith is not on the field, his offensive line is not the same, you know, and that was also a problem, a huge problem against Miami. Mm-hmm. Tyron Smith is back with, you know, if he's out again with that back injury, that's going to be a problem for the Cowboys offensive line. But they have to set the tone and help the defense out by, you know, scoring points. You know, this defense can be had, cannot stop the run when they need to. You saw that in Buffalo. You saw that against the Arizona Cardinals. You saw that against San Francisco. And certainly you saw that in Miami, especially they did okay against the run, but when they need to stop the run late, they couldn't get it done.
That's Clarence Hill Jr., the Fort Worth Star-Telegram. Make sure you're following him on all the socials if you want to stay up with what the Cowboys are doing. You brought up something, Clarence, that I find very interesting. You know, McCarthy and every football coach always talks about complementary football, the three phases helping each other. But does McCarthy, does that offense feel a little bit of added pressure that we have got to get points early? I mean, they have to get up early for them to protect that defense. And does that affect, or do you feel like that could be affecting McCarthy's play calling, or at least they're stumbling out of the block just because there's so much pressure to get an early lead?
Yeah, I mean, but they didn't necessarily stumble out of the block. They should have scored the opening drive. They did score in their second drive. But yeah, there's a you know, last week he tried to say, we don't have to protect our defense. But yeah, yes, you do. I mean, that's where we are. When the Cowboys are good, when they're at their best, is when they score early on offense and get things going and set the tone with the offense. That is the pressure, but it's been their reality. I mean, if you look at how they played, certainly when they went on won 7 of 8 games, is because they did get out and they did score and they did set the tone for the defense. And they did, you know, that's the way they win. You know, again, the dirty little secret is that we came to the season thinking the defense was the best part of this team. And now we realize it's the offense. The offense is the best part of this team. The defense is the one who can be a liability. And they have to do things with offense to help the defense out.
Well, what do we know on injuries? I know it's short week. They're playing Saturday night at 7. Keep in mind, a game you can catch live right here on San Antonio Sports Star. We know about Tyron. Anything else we need to be worried about over the week?
It didn't seem like anything came out of the game that was the Cowboys no worse for wear. I mean, the question is Tyron. That's been the question that's, you know, questioned all season. But it's, again, Tyron, it's a back, you know, and – you know, and those backs are tricky, you know, and so that's what you worry about, because Chuma Doga was downright awful at left tackle. Letting the best pass rusher, Bradley Chubb, go free at least two times, not more. I mean, what are you doing?
What are you doing? What are you doing is right.
Speaking of what are you doing, what is it with the Cowboys to where every season seems to hang on the health of Tyron Smith?
Well, every team's left tackle, man.
Well, yeah, but like at least most teams have, at least if there is a type of injury concern, they plan for that injury concern.
Well, the Cowboys did. They signed Chuma Doga in offseason. You know, that's what they did. They have Tyler Smith there to eventually replace him, but they gambled. They understood that. I mean, if you look at his contract is based on the game-by-game roster bonus and all of that stuff, but they gambled that they could manage him and get him through the season. They knew that there were games he would miss. But again, I don't know if they thought it'd be four. You know, he is not he's missed at least three games every season since 2015. Yeah. I know at least four games since 2020. That's a lot of games. And so that's been the deal, but they gambled that they could try to manage him and get him through the season and get him through the season healthy. But yeah, that's on the Cowboys. That's on the front office. But if, again, left tackle is like franchise quarterbacks starting growing on trees, you know, if they didn't address it in a draft, they didn't get a guard, they went for Mozzie Smith, you know, and they could have kicked Tyler out and, went with got somebody a guard instead of going with Mozzie Smith, who's done nothing. I've never seen a first-round pick, you know, just do nothing. You know,
that's not true. You reported on Taco Charlton.
There you go, Taco Charlton. They could have had TJ Watt, but he didn't fit the defense.
Oh, Clarence, it's too early in the morning for us to start regretting all this. You bring up the injuries and the offensive line, and certainly that's going to be the absolute key here of getting Tyron back. But on the defensive side of the ball, is there just the acceptance? I mean, this is what this team is, and when it comes down to stopping the run, it's just going to have – we're going to have to scheme absolutely perfectly. There's no other fix waiting out there other than Hankins coming back, right?
No, you hope you get Hankins back, and he could come back this week. I don't know. He thought about – you know, when we talked to him last week, and he said they would be hard-pressed to go against Miami, but he could be back for Detroit. You want to get Hankins back. And, you know, that's one reason why the Cowboys went after Shaq Leonard so hard, because they knew they were undersized and needed help stopping the run. They certainly need to be bigger at linebacker, but – outside of that, this is who they are. This is what they have to go with.
Clarence, sure. Real quick, what'd you think of did you get a chance to see the Baltimore 49er game last night? And if so, what'd you make of it?
The Brock Purdy meltdown. The Cam Newton somewhere smoking a cigar right now. I just want to let you guys know.
I'm sure he is.
I saw him smoking him on Twitter last night.
He's smoking a cigar. Oh, court to Cam Newton. But I mean, it's funny because I talked to a lot of Big 12 guys and they were like, this is the Brock Purdy we saw at Iowa State.
Right.
You know, and especially last year, and they're really surprised he'd been playing so well. And again, that's been the book. I mean, he's been a quarterback in perfect situations. You get your ball to your guys, but you put him under pressure, he will melt down and turn the ball over. Unfortunately, nobody was able to do it.
Nobody.
Until Baltimore did, and they did it, and he melted down in spectacular fashion.
Nobody does it like he does. That's Clarence Hill Jr., the Fort Worth Star-Telegram. We get him every Tuesday morning just about this time. We're glad you stopped by. I hope you had a wonderful holiday season, man. We'll talk to you next week.
Thank you, guys, man.
He is Clarence Hill Jr. He doesn't have to travel next week. Guys, Detroit arrives, and that home cooking might be exactly what ails the Cowboys.
And Clarence Hill Jr., of course, joining us via the Byers Barricades guest line. Byers Barricades provides traffic control, rental, and sales for San Antonio and beyond online at buyersbarricades.com.
Coming back, we got a whole lot of basketball to talk about, and hopefully it has nothing to do with the Spurs. But first, you ready for the bowl season? Because it's here.
What?
It's time to talk some – the bowls began, I guess, last Tuesday.
No, they didn't.
Well, I mean, when UTSA played.
Bowl season started?
It's here. We'll talk bowls. We'll talk Christmas white elephants. And then our favorite Christmas gift of all, Todd Archer of ESPN, will arrive just after 8 o'clock. Hang on. College football next. It's R&R here on 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star.
It's Dallas Cowboys football on 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star. This Saturday, the Cowboys welcome the Motor City Kitties to the Big D. It's a football beauty. Saturday night, Cowboys and Lions at 6:30.
Micah Parsons is on the ball.
And he's still alive.
He's still running to the goal line.
Presented by AA Best Bail Bonds, the Law Office of Jesse Hernandez, the Texas Chunk Law, Ewald Kubota, Mother's Window Tint, Woods Comfort Systems, and 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star.
Hi, I'm Jason Thompson. I'm a personal injury attorney, and since 1994, I've been helping people and their families seriously injured or killed by negligent drivers. My website, alawyerforus.com. I use that phrase because I know that there's no way a regular San Antonian can possibly beat a billion-dollar insurance company alone. You will need an experienced attorney to stand up for you and get what you and your family deserve. This month, my father will retire after 50 years of practicing law, doing what he taught me to do. Help people in need. Stand up for the people that cannot. Use the skills you have to help the people in your community when and where you can. As my father told me a long time ago, insurance companies are not trying to get to heaven. They're trying to make a profit. You cannot blame a lion for being a lion. Hire a hunter to help you. That's me. If you or a family member has been seriously injured because of a negligent driver, call me, Jason Thompson, as soon as you can after the collision. My number, 210-900-0400. That's 210-900-0400. Or check out my website, alawyerforus.com.
At Mr. W Fireworks, we have always offered the lowest prices on fireworks, and we always will. We never charge additional hidden fees, and we price our fireworks more than 50% less than the other guys. Visit MrWFireworks.com to find a location near you.
Mr. W Fireworks!
If you get arrested, get out of jail fast by calling AA Best Bail Bonds, 210-225-2121. Text BAIL to 474747 or online at mybestbailbonds.com. You don't have to call attorneys or anybody else. Don't be forced into a PR bond. If the jail offers you one, make sure you understand the conditions before accepting it. AA Best Bail Bonds, nobody beats their price. They have payment plans. Call 210-225-2121 or mybestbailbonds.com.
License number 149.
El Guacamole Mexican Grill is serving up your favorite Mexican dish. Visit them today at 25020 Blanco or call 210-499-5364 to place your order. Hot, fresh, made-to-order Mexican dishes. El Guacamole Mexican Grill.
America's Diamond has never sold lab-grown diamonds, and we warned our clients, friends, and neighbors that wholesale prices would crash to almost nothing. 2-carat GVS2 lab-grown diamonds are currently being traded at wholesale for $264, but some jewelers are still selling them online for $3,000 to $4,000. Repeat, wholesale $264, retail $3,000 to $4,000. Some retailers are selling 1-carat lab-grown diamonds for under $300, and others are giving them away for free with purchase. Lab-grown diamonds are very easy to detect with gemological equipment. Tens of millions of carats are produced in huge factories in China and India, using a tremendous amount of subsidized electricity supplied by coal-burning power plants. America's Diamond has only offered traditional, real, natural earth-grown diamonds that are rare, extremely beautiful, and have had real value for centuries. See our television program tonight on ABC KSAT 12 at 12:35 a.m. or right now at americasdiamond.com.
Guys, want to lose weight, improve your performance, and increase your drive? Revive Men's Health San Antonio can help you address the root causes of weight gain, low energy, poor drive, and performance issues. And since your testosterone level has a direct impact on your weight and fitness, we'll give you a free T-check and free exam at Revive San Antonio. Imagine upping your game, losing weight, and getting in shape all at once. Revive can help you make it happen with our new cutting-edge weight loss medications like your favorite athletes and celebrities use. They're affordable and available now. Weight gain and low T are treatable conditions. We know we can help you. Take that first step and book today. You're only one step away from getting in the best shape of your life. Call Revive Men's Health at 210-615-7777. That's 210-615-7777 or visit revivemenshealth.com.
When something happens to your kitchen, you might say,
"This is ludicrous."
But that won't fix your home. That will only get you the rapper Ludacris.
Having trouble? Don't panic. Don't be alarmed. You need to file a claim? Holla at State Farm. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
That's right. You can file a claim on the app or call us.
Thanks, Mr. Chris.
No matter how ludicrous the situation, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
State Farm, Bloomington, Illinois.
Prescriptions require an online consultation with a healthcare provider who will determine if appropriate restrictions apply. See website for details and important safety information. Subscription required. Price varies based on product and subscription plan.
Hey guys, did you know there's a generic form of Viagra that works just the same, but is 95% cheaper, and you can get it online? Go to hims.com/joy. Through Hims, you'll get a free medical consultation, discreet shipping if prescribed, and the process is 100% online. To start your free online visit, go to hims.com/joy. That's hims.com/joy.
This is Andrew Monaco, and you're listening to the home of the Aggies, 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star.
It's R&R here on San Antonio Sports Star. No Rudy today, but I am joined by the former cast of characters known as the Saturday Morning Hangover. He is James Pledger, current co-host of Extra Innings Every Day. Catch him live today. He got a full one. He'll be here all day long. My son, Jack Thompson, the other half of Saturday Morning Hangover, sitting in with us as well today. We've made it to December the 26th, and it doesn't really feel like the bowl season has kicked in. You feeling? Well, I mean, how many bowls have you watched? Legitimately, sat down and watched, other than UTSA, because that was more of a home game.
UTSA and Tech. That's it.
In Tech, that was it. We got games tonight, and all week long. I got the Alamo Bowl coming up this weekend. Tomorrow we're busy. We'll start.
How busy?
At 4 o'clock with the Duke's Mayo Bowl, the Texas Bowl, as the Aggies get busy. What are you laughing at?
Duke's Mayo Bowl. I mean, come on. Imagine Jeff Traylor got dunked with Scooter's coffee.
Oh, the mayonnaise dump?
Imagine getting just coated in mayonnaise after a win.
Are you getting ready? We're a week out. Under a week from
6 days.
Does it feel like it's coming? I'm not quite there yet.
I'm not there yet, but I think as the weekend gets closer, I will feel, because we're still such a long ways out from it actually being here.
Right.
In terms of, all right, I can start getting ready for Washington like Thursday. You know, Texas is big, folks. And then after that, start getting ready for Alabama in Houston at NRG Stadium the following week.
It's been awfully quiet on the four team front that are playing in the true playoff.
I mean, I think that's kind of how they want it.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, you know, you wonder when this kind of long break, and you have the differences between those that have been here and those that haven't. You
only
just feel like
been there and they play each other.
Right. You just feel like those on one side of the bracket is where these two teams are going to be fully prepared. I have no idea what to expect between Texas and Washington. I really don't have any idea what to expect.
Because of the layoff, mostly. Like, I think I know what to expect if they were to play each other as soon as the next week, right?
I would have thought it would have been a 55-50 shootout if they'd have played each other a month ago. Oh, I really would have. I don't think it's going to be that way.
See, I think both of these teams really like to run the football, and Washington loves to impose running the football, but Texas is dominant at stopping the run with Tavondre Sweat and Byron Murphy.
Yeah.
Let's talk with Todd Archer of the Dallas of the ESPN about the Dallas Cowboy game. Cowboys go down, but did it really hurt that bad? We'll talk with Archer next. This is R&R. You're on 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star. You know, when you're a member and a patient at the Institute for Functional Health, the holidays are never easy. You know, you're looking at days where there's all kinds of trash in front of you. Of course, you're going to eat it because it is the season, right? Well, that's one of the great things about the Institute for Functional Health and Dr. Jacob Torres is once you go there and you start to understand how your body works, because he'll teach you, and you start to understand why diets are effective and why some diets aren't. You understand that you can, I don't use the word cheat, but you can take advantage of what is in front of you for the short term, knowing full well that the lifestyle you're living will allow you to continue to lose weight. It's just one of the many benefits of going to some place like the Institute for Functional Health, because you're part of a team. Not only are you going to run the plays like Dr. Torres has run, but you'll play a role in how things go. But he understands, and you will too, why the body works the way it does and why you put on weight. You'll learn that and how you take it off. Everybody's different, and the programs that he puts together reflect that, but there are some basic things in science that do not change. You lower your caloric intake, you burn more calories than you put in. Normally, you're going to lose weight. Now, he also understands underlying factors help to get you to where you are. So when it's time to lose weight, those are addressed. And that's why he's been so successful. Life isn't easy when you're trying to lose weight. Everybody else is eating good. It's hard for you to continue. Well, guess what? You'll eat good too. Call Dr. Torres today and find out what I know. You know, it's a conversation that needs to be had by everybody. You need to be told the truth. There's no miracle weight loss out there. There is no easy, easy drop, and then you just keep it off. You've got to learn how to do it. And Coach Dr. Torres is the best. The number you need is 468-1891. Call him today. Change your life in 2024. Become a new and thinner you. I know you can do it. Just decide to do it. And once you've resolved, step through the door and go to the Institute for Functional Health. And when you do, you'll be successful. I want you to thank me later.
The Jim Rome Show.
Hey, Jim Rome here. And back in the military city of San Antonio.
Weekdays at noon on 94.1 San Antonio's Sports Star.
Joe, I've invented the perfect exercise machine. It's practical, efficient, and fits in any home. I give you the Row and Go. Ta-da! It's a rowing machine that connects to your toilet, so you can row and...
Stop. Folks, at Quarter Moon Plumbing, Heat, and AC, we help homes stay in tip-top shape. Call Quarter Moon, 651-5899.
Quarter Moon Plumbing, Heat, and AC, 210-651-5899.
License number M16004, DACLA 000743-45E.
Sadly, millions of pets are euthanized in America every year because the shelters lack the funding to care for them. We are better than that, my friends. I'm John O'Hurley, and I invite you to make an $11 monthly donation to the Puppy Food Bank. Your $11 donation will allow the Puppy Food Bank to direct ship pet food to San Antonio rescue shelters. To help save a pet's life, donate $11 today at puppyfoodbank.org, and they'll send you a very special gift. This pet rescue message has been brought to you by Thomas J. Henry.
I've always gotten tons of UTIs. Cranberry products never worked for me, and I was desperate for a way to be proactive. I'm Jenna Ryan, CEO and founder of Eucora. We've worked with doctors to develop effective urinary tract health products. Just mix a packet of Eucora with water and drink it when you need support, like right after intimacy. Eucora is helping over 100,000 women stay healthy. Ready to join them? Get 30% off at eucora.com/radio. That's eucora.com/radio.
A holiday message from Jackson Hewitt.
Jingle bells, all the way. Oh, what fun it is to get money the same day.
Starting December 11th, walk into a Jackson Hewitt for an early loan on your tax refund, and you could walk out with up to $1,000.
Jingle bells, all the way. Oh, what fun it is to get money. Missing out would be cray.
Appointments go fast. Book yours now at jacksonhewitt.com. Early refund advance offered to eligible clients. Application required. Finance charge applies. Loans by Republic Bank. Details at jacksonhewitt.com.
Accused of a crime? Our team of former prosecutors turned criminal defense attorneys can help you be a step ahead of your legal problem. The LaHood and Norton Law Group knows both sides of the criminal justice system. Our team is your best defense. Let us be your legal bodyguards. We can handle all criminal cases, state or federal. Call us to review your case at 210-797-7700.
Stop paying all those crazy fees on ticket apps. Need tickets? Stay local and call Awesome Tickets. Big games, big concerts, big events. Awesome Tickets is your personal ticket broker. Any city, any event. Awesome Tickets has your tickets for all the sports, concerts, and events from San Antonio to Las Vegas. Avoid the ticket app fees. Since 1994, Awesome Tickets is local and veteran-owned. Call 210-226-5136 or online at awesometix.com. That's awesometix.com.
If you have unfiled taxes or are in debt to the IRS, this is important news. The IRS just rolled out a new program to help struggling taxpayers more easily resolve their tax problems. It's called the Taxpayer Relief Initiative, and it opens up powerful new options for people looking to get back on the right track with the IRS. And no one knows this program like the professionals at Optima Tax Relief, America's most trusted tax resolution company. They've resolved over $1 billion in tax debt for their clients and have the expertise and experience to help you. One easy call to Optima can start the process, helping to put an end to your worries of wage garnishment, asset seizure, and other aggressive IRS actions. Make today the beginning of your fresh start with the IRS. Call the experts at Optima Tax Relief now for your free confidential consultation.
Call 800-714-8422. 800-714-8422. 800-714-8422.
Optima Tax Relief.
Some restrictions apply. For complete details, please visit OptimaTaxRelief.com.
On your ride to work, check out Rob Thompson and Rudy J. They're R&R in the Morning, KTFM Floresville, and at SASportsStar.com. San Antonio's Sports Center.
Spurs have lost four straight as they return to action tonight at the Frost Bank Center to take on the Utah Jazz. Tip-off set for 7 o'clock. In college football, Texas Longhorns landed former UTSA and AAC Defensive Player of the Year, Trey Moore, via the transfer portal. Texas did lose, however, their backup quarter, Malik Murphy, who is transferring to Duke. Todd Archer's next with the latest on the Dallas Cowboys.
It's 0600. What's the O stand for? Oh, my God, it's early.
Rob Thompson.
Did all believe the other way in transition to the power with a left hand slam.
I want some nasty.
Rudy J.
Cowboys win. How else would you settle this game?
Begin each day as if it were on purpose.
I wake up in the morning, I piss excellent.
R&R in the Morning on 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star.
Good morning.
Good morning to you. It's R&R in the Morning here on San Antonio Sports Star. I'm Rob Thompson. There is no Rudy J. He is continuing his vacay. And instead, the cast and crew of the former Saturday Morning Hangover. That's James Pledger. Jack Thompson sitting beside me, Eazy-E driving this boat. Let's talk some Dallas Cowboys. Yeah, they went into Miami, fought hard, and go down 22-20. Let's talk about it with one of the best. Todd Archer of ESPN sitting in with us. Morning, Todd. Merry Christmas. Happy holidays and Happy New Year to you for coming up. How you doing this morning?
I'm doing right. Appreciate it. And same back to all you guys.
Okay. As we sit on a Tuesday morning on a short week, as they've got a Saturday night game, what was the general attitude of the team as they got off the plane? Was it one of a valid effort that was, you know, just nullified by, a last second drive? Or was there, ongoing concern? Heck, if we have to stop the run, there's no way we can do it.
I think, in that locker room after the game, it was surprising to me to hear them almost to a man say, all the confidence in the world, we can do this. We haven't yet, but we can, was something that Dak said. The defense, I thought the run defense was 91 yards. I thought it was obviously much improved against Miami than it was against Buffalo. You only give up 22 points to that offense. I think you feel pretty good about yourself. I was a little surprised that, again, they weren't claiming moral victories, but I was surprised that they felt almost the way they did walking out of Philadelphia back in, when was that, October? It's a lifetime ago. And that they still think, okay, yeah, we lost on the road, but hey, we're going to have to go there, but we can still get this done. That was a little surprising to me that there wasn't a, not they want to be defeated, but just a more, less optimistic tone than what they were saying in that locker room.
Is that just a reflection of the company line that they've been told to say? Do you get the sense they believe it?
I get the sense they believe it, to be honest with you. And both things that you just said there could be true. It's the company line and they believe it. You can look at it. Okay, Philadelphia game. We talked about after that one. It was a game of inches. Dak stepping out of bounds on the two-pointer. Schoonmaker not getting up, one more foot or an inch, scoring a touchdown. And then this one, it's a game of inches. And we can talk about the Lipke fumble on the opening drive. But honestly, they probably should have scored on the first two plays there on the Cooks reverse and on the Pollard run. Like, he should have – both those guys should have scored before Lipke even fumbled. So you score there, it's a different result at the end of the game. But there's still moments in that Miami game where it's like, offense, where'd you go? You were great those first two drives, and I think the next four possessions, they gained 9 yards. Like, that can't happen when you're playing good teams in playoff football.
Todd, I don't mean this in a disparaging way, but the Cowboys kind of seem like a front-running team.
I'm thinking you do.
And I don't.
This has really become disparaging.
It's kind of who they are in a sense of they get a lead, they play with a lead, they allow their defense to unleash itself, and that's the best possible way for them to play, because when they get into these close games that they have to gut out and try and win, or the defense is put in a position where there's a stop needed at the end of the game to kind of ice it away, they're not as productive in those situations than they are when they're playing at their best, which is grab a lead early and let that defense go to work.
Absolutely. I agree with you. And I don't think that's a 2023 thing. I think that's been a Cowboy thing for years now. You know what I mean? And the only game that kind of goes against that would have been Seattle, because the defense did make some stops at the end and the offense was able to come back and make key plays in key moments. But again, where are you in the other big games that you needed? And all these numbers that they put up, especially at home, averaging nearly 40 points a game, take Philadelphia out of it, are largely against subpar teams. So, yeah, what are you going to do when you're not playing a subpar team? No, they might, I guess, in the wild card round, right? But when you're not playing a subpar team in the playoffs, what are you going to do, and where does the confidence come from that you can do it? And again, I would say this is not a 2023 Cowboys issue. It's right. been an issue for this club. I don't know. Go back to the Romo times, right? I mean, whether the defense makes a play, the offense can't get anything going. Think of those three straight 8 and 8 years.
Right.
Or the defense makes some plays and the offense can't even go. Heck, just go back to last Sunday. Like, it was Sunday. My days are all screwed up. I didn't leave Miami game thinking, man, that defense, they got a lot of problems. I left it more as the offense has to do more. They got to do more and score 20 points and cash in on these opportunities that you have, especially in that opening drive. And it was weird that Hunter Lipke entered that game with 6 touches on the season, and they gave him the ball 4 times on that drive.
Mm-hmm. And a little weird. Did not go well at all. Todd Archer of ESPN joining us here on San Antonio Sports Star. You know, of course, we're going to talk about the inability to stop the run when it absolutely mattered. Though, when you look at the numbers, the box score says that Dan Quinn's defense was effective. They held Tariq underneath 100 yards. I mean, 100. He was a threat all day long. And I think it opened up some other stuff for him. But for the most part, that defense worked. You brought it up with the offense. Does the offense lay the problems on Tyron Smith not being there in the first half? What happened?
Well, it was really the end where the pressure and the that Miami was putting. Like, Chubb is number 2. He's their best pass rusher.
Mm-hmm.
Block that guy. Like, why are they turning him unloose? Like, no one even goes to block the dude. So I think that was a big part of their issues. It was their protection in that game. And they didn't really run it very well at all. But, they didn't run the ball well when Tyron was playing on the road, either. So they missed Tyron. Don't get me wrong. But I think this has to become a team that it can't always be perfect for them to win. You guys just mentioned it. They have to win some of these muck it up type of games where you're not at your best and you somehow pull it out and you rise to the occasion. Again, I'll say that the defense did enough, not on that last drive, but over the course of 4 quarters, did enough for the Cowboys to leave that game with a win. To me, it was the offense that first drive, not getting any points out of there. It's a 10-point swing in a 2-point game. That kind of spells a difference.
Over the last couple of weeks, there's been this narrative, Todd, of did that loss really hurt? Uncommon opponent, Buffalo, Miami, the other teams in the NFC had lost, so they're still kind of in it. The game's not really of importance. They know where they are in their playoff positioning. For the most part, they clinched a playoff spot before the Buffalo game even happened. And McCarthy talked a couple of weeks ago about playoff games without playoff consequences. Is the lack of consequences creating a lack of importance on these games in terms of the mindset going into them?
I don't want to go there because they could still, the division was still there. Playing a home playoff game was still there. So there were consequences to these games, just not, quote, playoff consequences when your season's over. So I don't think the guys looked at it and said, no big deal. We'll figure this out when we get to the second week in January for the playoffs, or third week, I guess it is. So I don't want to go there, but I do agree with your point, and I'll take it a little step further. Is okay, these are playoff games without playoff consequences. If you don't win any of these games, then there's a consequence to that. When you get to the playoffs, and there's real consequences on the line, where does the confidence come from that you can turn it up and turn it on when you need it most?
Dak Prescott went 20 of 32 for 253, two touchdowns, and what was an acceptable to very good performance, I felt like. What do you make about while the numbers look good and CD can look at the box and say, I got 100 yards and six catches, he got lost in the second half. Brandon Cooks got lost. I mean, what do we make about the inexplicable inability to throw the ball there late or in the second half?
Well, yeah, it was CD Lamb didn't have a touch in the second and third quarter. And then his first touch in the fourth quarter was on a run. So then, and then they finally got him the ball. That lull that they called it, Zach Martin told me that after the game, is really where that lost the game for them. And I don't know if they were slow on the adjustments to what Vic Fangio did, or it was just a lack of execution. Whatever it is, that four or five possession stretch where you did nothing. And yeah, you were backed up on two of them, maybe coming out of your goal line. It's okay to get a first down. Like, it's still that's allowable.
Right.
Even if you're at your own two, you know, you can do some things. And, you know, you mentioned, like, you know, Dak's numbers look good. Two touchdowns, 250 something yards. Mm-hmm. But there were times that I thought in that lull where he went to the wrong guy or he didn't see a guy. Like, there was a couple of times where CD was open in that quarter where it's like, dude, just throw it to him. He's going to get you 8 yards. And, you know, you, maybe even a first down after that. There were times it was almost like, and I'm sure he wasn't, but he's like, well, I got to get it to Gallup here. Well, I got to get it to Ferguson here. Well, I got to get it to this guy here. Instead of just saying, okay, that's my best player. I'm going to number 88 whenever and wherever I can.
In the first half, was Jalen Ramsey following CD or no. Was that a second half thing?
They didn't really do that much at all, even in the throughout the course of the game, even when CD's wasn't getting targeted. It wasn't anything really different than the first couple of possessions. When CD went in motion, you didn't see number five going with them. They played their defense. I think one thing that they did do a better job was their linebackers, as Dak said, they fogged some things up on the coverage of where things were. And they maybe were a little bit more physical with CD at the line than they were in the first, certainly the first quarter when he went off. So I don't think it was the Jalen Ramsey effect either that did anything to take CD out of it. In some respects, I think the Cowboys took CD out of it.
I don't think it's hyperbole or grandiose to say that the best two players on offense are CD Lamb and Dak Prescott. And this offense is at its best when those two are going to work. So when they talk about these lulls between the two in terms of what happened in the middle of the Miami game, isn't there a point as a play caller with Mike McCarthy to where he has to basically reestablish to the point like, hey, we've got to get the ball into our best players' hands?
Well, and I think you saw that, certainly not in the second and third quarter, but that long drive, fourth down, who did he go to? CD. He had a long cross, long corner route where he threw it to CD. That might have been his first catch of the fourth quarter. So when it was that big time need a play, they were going to CD. And there's an element. It's weird when you say, like, they have to feed him more because they feed him a lot. It was just it was the first time this season that he went two straight quarters without being targeted.
Wow, that's inexcusable.
That's saying something.
That's inexcusable. Right there. Let's talk about this offense, though. Certainly coming home will cure what ails them. They're looking to set a couple of records, but one of them be the first team or the fourth team in NFL history to average 40 points a game at home. They've scored 30 points in eight straight home games. That's third longest streak since Peyton Manning and the Broncos and that Rams team. That the offense coming home, how much of it is just about coming home and finding that groove? Or is it a week 18 next week? Are we playing for the playoffs now, or is there still a worthy chase to get this offense cooking and, you know, maybe win a NFC East? I don't know. What's the motivation for the next 2 weeks?
Yeah, no, you're playing a team that has as many wins as anybody in football right now, right? Everybody's got Detroit, San Fran, and Baltimore all of 11.
Right.
No one else has more than that. So you're beating a, quote, good team. Like, you're facing a good team, a team that you could face in the playoffs. Now, I think Detroit has some road issues as well, where they might not be the same as they are when they play inside Ford Field. But this is a playoff game for the Cowboys. And again, okay, if you lose, the season isn't over. But you win this one, it might not change the perception of what everybody outside of you thinks, but it certainly helps your own perception of what you believe you can be. Because I think I wrote this after the game. This Cowboys season was always going to be defined of what they did when they got to the playoffs. It didn't matter, you know, if you went 17-0 or 9-8. It was going to be what you did when you got in the playoffs, and that because everybody's tired of wild card or divisional round and out. So if you win this game, it doesn't change our opinion maybe of what the season could be, but it helps them to get that win when they go to Tampa or New Orleans or wherever they're going to go in the first round, and then either San Francisco or Philly or Detroit, I guess, in the second round. So there's a lot on the line this week for the Cowboys beyond, hey, you know, let's average 40 points a game at home. Let's go undefeated at home. This is a win the game and gain some confidence and get into Washington. As Dak said, maybe that's the game that starts the road streak if they win at FedEx Field. If they don't win at FedEx Field, whew, man, I mean, forget about what happens in the playoffs, because they'll be – I don't know where the confidence comes from that you can win on the road when you're going to – you would end up being 3-6 away from home if you were to lose that one.
Todd, real quick, I know we're up against it. What did you think of San Francisco last night? Did that tell you anything?
It tells me Baltimore's really good. And in that San Francisco's not fallible. Like, you can beat them. And you got to play your best, especially the Cowboys. I just think for the Cowboys' history in these last couple seasons in the playoffs, why would we believe that the Cowboys can go there and win? But I think for the Cowboys, they would say, okay, there's a little bit of a chance here. If Purdy's hurt, if Trent Williams is hurt, that certainly helps as well. But they're 10. You take the big picture view and say, hey, they're 10-5, and there's not a great 85 Bears team out there that they can compete with. They can compete with everybody. And the question is, can they beat everybody? And I think there's probably at least San Francisco in the NFC that you'd say, I don't see that one.
With the lackluster into the season, and this didn't even cross my mind until you brought up, if they lose in Washington, oh boy. But if they lose in Washington, oh boy. And then fall short in the first round of the playoffs on the road again. There hasn't been talk about McCarthy's job to an extent, but would that start a conversation on the inside?
On the inside is tough to say, because I'm not getting into 81-year-old Jerry Jones's mind at this point. But I would say the conversation would start outside. And I think, again, you go back to what the beginning of the season was all about. It was about doing more than just getting to the wild card, just getting to the playoffs or through a wild card or through a divisional round. It was about doing more. Mike McCarthy was brought here to do what Jason Garrett couldn't do. This would be three straight early playoff exits, if you want to call it early. I think it would be the questions would be asked. And I think some people in the building would be asking that question. I just don't know if Jerry and Steven would be asking that question.
That's Todd Archer at BSP, and we get him every week, and we're glad he came by. Man, we hope you had a happy holiday. Enjoy this week. We'll talk to you next week.
Sounds good. Thanks, fellas.
Todd Archer, BSP, and right here on San Antonio Sports Star. What a strange week it turned out to be. Whenever we have guests of his ilk, they come to us via the Buyer's Barricade guest line. When we come back, man, oh, man, the NBA is cooking, but the Spurs aren't part of the menu. We're going to talk some league NBA. We're going to talk about what we witnessed over the ceremonial beginning of the NBA season. Or is it? NBA talk coming your direction. This is R&R, and you're on 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star.
As the weather gets colder, the NFL offers stay hot on FanDuel. Right now, new customers get $150 in bonus bets with any winning $5 moneyline bet. That's $150 if your team wins. If you've been thinking about joining FanDuel, there's no better time to get in on the action. The app is so easy to use. There's a wide range of betting options, spreads, player props, over-unders, and more. So visit FanDuel.com/win and kick off the NFL season. That's FanDuel.com/win. FanDuel, official partner of the NFL.
Must be 21 plus and present in state. We're offered a wager. FanDuel is offering online sports wagering in Kansas under an agreement with Kansas Star Casino, LLC. First online real money wager only. $5 pregame money line wager required. First online real money wager only. $10 first deposit required. Bonus issued is non-withdrawable bonus bets that expire 7 days after receipt. See terms at sportsbook.fanduel.com. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-GAMBLER or visit fanduel.com/RG in Colorado, Iowa, Michigan, New Jersey, Ohio, Pennsylvania, Illinois, Kentucky, Tennessee, and Virginia. Call 1-800-NEXT-STEP or text NEXT-STEP to 53342 in Arizona, 1-888-789-7777 or visit ccpg.org/chat in Connecticut. 1-800-9-WITH-IT in Indiana, 1-800-522-4700. Visit ksgamblinghelp.com in Kansas, 1-877-770-STOP in Louisiana. Visit mdgamblinghelp.org in Maryland. Visit 1-800-GAMBLER.net in West Virginia or call 1-800-522-4700 in Wyoming. Help is here. Visit gamblinghelpma.org or call 1-800-327-5050 for 24/7 support in Massachusetts or call 1-877-8-HOPE-NY or text OpenY in New York.
What's holding you back from learning the language you've always wanted to know?
Too hard.
Takes too long.
Not with Babbel. Babbel's lessons take just 15 minutes a day.
15 minutes isn't long.
Nope. And they're fun. So you don't realize you're learning a language, but you are. In 3 weeks, you're able to start having conversations. And Babbel's lessons are built around real life.
And with Babbel, it isn't hard. It's perfect.
Start learning a new language today. Go to Babbel.com. That's BABBEL.com.
Finding great candidates to hire can be like, well, trying to find a needle in a haystack, but not with ZipRecruiter. Its powerful technology actively finds and invites qualified candidates to apply to your job. So while other companies might deliver a lot of hay, ZipRecruiter finds you the needle in the haystack.
See why 4 out of 5 employers who post a job on ZipRecruiter get a quality candidate within the first day. Try ZipRecruiter for free at ziprecruiter.com/free. That's ziprecruiter.com/free.
The South Texas RV Super Sale is back at Freeman Expo Hall. And boy, do we have a great show this year. Hundreds of RVs, every shape and size. All dealers are ready to sell. You'll get the best prices of the year, January 4th through the 7th. South Texas RV SuperSale.com.
Ready to change your phone service? You got to check out Boost Infinite Wireless at BoostInfinite.com. You get their low-priced service and a brand new iPhone every year. And Boost Infinite's new technology gives you 3 networks for the price of 1. So you get the best quality calls and data anywhere you are. No one can do that except Boost. Switch today at BoostInfinite.com or call 855-55-BOOST. See BoostInfinite.com for terms and conditions.
The venue's set. Families coming in from all over. It's her quinceañera. With all the excitement, it may be easy to overlook COVID-19. It's still a risk, and that's why it's muy importante to get this season's COVID-19 shot ahead of time. It helps protect against COVID-19, which can cause severe illness and hospitalization. So let's set the date. Vaccinate and celebrate. Learn about a vaccine option and book this season's updated COVID-19 shot today at ScheduleCOVIDVax.com. Sponsored by Pfizer.
Why is the world's number one selling brand of chainsaws not sold at Lowe's or the Home Depot? We can give you over 10,000 reasons. That's how many authorized local steel dealers you can find across the country. Visit one and you'll find a range of dependable gas and battery-powered tools. From trimmers and blowers to mowers and more, trusted by homeowners and pros all over the world. And you'll find service and help from experienced professionals. Real Steel. Find yours at steeldealers.com. Lowe's and Home Depot are trademarks for their respective companies.
Hi, I'm Jason Thompson. I'm a personal injury attorney, and since 1994, I've been helping people and their families seriously injured or killed by negligent drivers. My website is alawyerforus.com. I use that phrase because I know that there's no way a regular San Antonian can possibly beat a billion-dollar insurance company alone. You will need an experienced attorney to stand up for you and get what you and your family deserve. This month, my father will retire after 50 years of practicing law, doing what he taught me to do, help people in need. Stand up for the people that cannot. Use the skills you have to help the people in your community when and where you can. When an insured driver seriously injures someone, a billion-dollar insurance company uses everything it can to pay as little as possible. Every insurance company you have heard of has a very large staff of attorneys already working against you. If you or a family member has been seriously injured because of a negligent driver, call me, Jason Thompson, as soon as you can after a collision. My number is 210-900-0400. That's 210-900-0400. Or check out my website, alawyerforus.com.
Listen to this station anytime, anywhere on Odyssey. Odyssey is your new audio home for all the music, news, sports, and podcasts that matter to you. Odyssey. That's A-U-D-A-C-Y.
Good morning, everybody. Joe Reinagle here. I hope everybody had a great Christmas. We certainly did. It's going to be great to get back to react to all of the things that happened over the weekend, including that horrible loss to the Miami Dolphins. What is going on with the Dallas Cowboys? Shereen Williams will join us. That's coming up at 5:15. And Indy Kalu will talk about C.J. Stroud and when he's coming back when he joins us at 3:30. Hey, Rob, Pledge, hope you guys had a great Christmas.
Thank you, Joe.
Had a wonderful, wonderful holiday. You get anything weird? What's the weirdest gift you got?
Weirdest gift I got?
Well, I got a clock that doesn't read time. It gives you the time in words.
What?
It's like a big square clock with a bunch of letters, and it doesn't say. It says the time is, and it just every time it changes from the it just 11 after 5. Or
so
five
you got 11. A useless piece of equipment.
Well, no, it combines my two favorite things: reading and telling time.
So does it say like 11 E L E V?
Yeah, it writes out the and it says the time is now and it when I guess.
Okay.
It's I don't know. That's it was part of our white elephant gift. I was given a bonsai, starter
you weren't
set.
Given it. You chose.
Well,
it.
I had it for a brief moment because it was stolen
from
me.
Kid?
Well, I'd never grown
a
bonsai.
That. I stole it from him when it was my turn.
I had that for a bit.
So
I had some hot sauce
this
for
white
a bit.
Elephant.
Well, like, we all buy gifts, all 14 of us.
That's when you got the survival kit, right?
I gave a survival kit. My son Clay ended up with that. no one knows who bought what. And then
it's your turn. You either
draw,
pick a new gift or you
can
steal one
somebody's
that's been
gift.
Open.
How many steals do you get?
You get three. There's three steals per gift, but it's so unlimited steals until something reaches three.
That gift is stuck on three. Got it. I like white elephants.
Oh, that was fun. It was a lot of fun. All the gifts were good too.
None of them were crazy, although Jack got iced.
Yeah, I did get iced.
You got iced.
But that wasn't from
the
white elephant.
That was Secret Santa.
Things have changed in your house when you go from putting together toys and eating the cookies before Santa gets up and doing all the stuff that you do to make sure that the kids have a great Christmas with their toys, to the point where your oldest son is having to shotgun a Smirnoff Ice at 9 a.m. because he got iced.
I think that's the best way to start.
I mean, that times have changed around the Thompson compound for Christmas when the youngest are all the kids are now doing shots. the parents are trying to keep up.
I mean, if you're not starting your Christmas with a Bloody Mary or at least a mimosa, are you even doing Christmas?
Although I've had no eggnog. Have you had any nog?
Some nog.
Did you have some?
I've
didn't have any nog.
Oh, I've been nogging.
I've been nogging for weeks.
We had snort juice, but that's about all we could manage.
What?
You ever had snort juice?
What the heck is snort?
It's the nog.
No, it's just
or snork.
It's snork. It's the noise you make after you drink it. You drink it and you get a little snork action because that's what keeps you going. And God,
that's what we call every batch of
whatever we make.
Yeah.
Snort juice. From our family to yours, we continue the snort juice offerings coming back. Let's talk some NBA. The Celtics laid down the law. The Spurs continued doing what they're doing, and Utah is coming to town. The gumbo's hot. It's too bad the Spurs are not. NBA talk coming. This is R&R, and you're on 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star. The week between Christmas and New Year's is traditionally a week off, right? There's things to get done around the house, and if you're in pain, it's very difficult to get those things going. Arosti is around right now to get you fixed. Arosti providers all around San Antonio here with one job in mind, and that is to get you out of pain. And the way they do it is absolutely unique, and it doesn't really matter the type of pain you're dealing with. It's what they do to get it fixed. When you walk into an Arosti provider, the first thing they do is give you a full evaluation. They're going to find out why you're in pain. And, the interesting thing about that is sometimes the reason you're in pain and the place you're in pain is not where the reason is. I found that out with my lower back. I had lower back issues most of my adult life, and I found out my first visit to Arosti, it wasn't my back, it was my hamstrings. They worked on that, and my back got better. Amazing. That's what they can do for you. And they do it fast, on average, under 4 visits. Arosti providers all around San Antonio can get you fixed and get you fixed fast, and they can take care of you today. Because guess what? They don't need a referral. You can go ahead and make that call. Write the number down. It's 1-800-404-6050. I know you're dialing a 1-800 number. It's a local call. They'll get you set up immediately, and they'll get you fixed. They're all around San Antonio, these providers. If you want to prove it to yourself, go to the website, arosti.com. They have a map there. I bet there's one less than 10 minutes from where you are now. Listen close. Don't let pain keep you from doing things that you love. There's a fix out there. It's Arosti. Call them today. Let them get them working on you. And before you know it, you'll be back in the game. And I know you're going to thank me later.
It's Dallas Cowboys football on 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star. This Saturday, the Cowboys welcome the Motor City Kitties to the Big D. It's a football beauty. Saturday night, Cowboys and Lions at 6:30.
Micah Parsons is on the ball.
And he's still alive.
He's still running to the goal line.
Presented by AA Best Bail Bonds, the Law Office of Jesse Hernandez, the Texas Chunk Law, Ewald Kubota, Mother's Window Tint, Woods Comfort Systems, and 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star.
Listen up.
At Mr. W Fireworks, we have always offered the lowest prices on fireworks.
And we always will.
We never charge additional hidden fees, and we price our fireworks more than 50% less than the other guys.
No joke.
When you shop at Mr. W Fireworks, you can be sure you are getting the lowest prices on fireworks around. And the biggest selection. Just look for the W on our sign and you're in the right place. Visit MrWFireworks.com to find a location near you.
Mr. W Firewood.
From our family to yours.
Happy New Year!
Guys, want to lose weight, improve your performance, and increase your drive? Revive Men's Health San Antonio can help you address the root causes of weight gain, low energy, poor drive, and performance issues. And since your testosterone level has a direct impact on your weight and fitness, we'll give you a free T-check and free exam at Revive San Antonio. Imagine upping your game, losing weight, and getting in shape all at once. Revive can help you make it happen with our new cutting-edge weight loss medications like your favorite athletes and celebrities use. They're affordable and available now. Weight gain and low T are treatable conditions. We know we can help you. Take that first step and book today. You're only one step away from getting in the best shape of your life. Call Revive Men's Health at 210-615-7777. That's 210-615-7777. Or visit RevivemensHealth.com.
When something happens to your kitchen, you might say,
"This is ludicrous."
But that won't fix your home. That will only get you the rapper, Ludacris.
Having trouble? Don't panic. Don't be alarmed. You need to file a claim? Holla at State Farm. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
That's right. You can file a claim on the app or call us.
Thanks, Mr. Chris.
No matter how ludicrous the situation, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
State Farm, Bloomington, Illinois.
Prescriptions require an online consultation with a healthcare provider who will determine if appropriate restrictions apply. See website for details and important safety information. Subscription required. Price varies based on product and subscription plan.
Hey guys, did you know there's a generic form of Viagra that works just the same, but is 95% cheaper, and you can get it online? Go to Hims.com/joy. Through Hims, you'll get a free medical consultation, discreet shipping if prescribed, and the process is 100% online. To start your free online visit, go to Hims.com/joy. That's Hims.com/joy.
Pete after betrayal.
I didn't see it coming. Life can be so unpredictable. After losing my dad, it made me think about my family if something were to happen to me. The mortgage, car payments, and all the other bills. Even things like our annual summer vacation would be out of reach. I had heard about life insurance through Ethos and how easy it was to get coverage. They were right. I knew it was time to stop putting it off and get life insurance right now. I got on my computer and went to ethoslife.com. In just 10 minutes, I was covered. And boom, family protected. Thanks to Ethos, my family won't have to worry about the bills if the unpredictable happens to me.
Ethos, fast and easy online term life insurance. Up to $2 million in coverage with no medical exam. Some policies as low as $1 a day. Answer a few health questions and get your free quote at getethos.com. That's G-E-T-E-T-H-O-S.com.
If you get arrested, get out of jail fast by calling AA Best Bail Bonds, 210-225-2121. Text BAIL to 474747 or online at mybestbailbonds.com. You don't have to call attorneys or anybody else. Don't be forced into a PR bond. If the jail offers you one, make sure you understand the conditions before accepting it. AA Best Bail Bonds, nobody beats their price. They have payment plans. Call 210-225-2121 or mybestbailbonds.com.
License number 149.
It's the Mike McCarthy Show, every Friday morning at 7 and 9 with R&R in the Morning.
I'm all about winning, so when it has to do with winning, then it's part of our operation, our messaging, and our outlook.
A look at the Cowboys' upcoming game, presented by AA Best Bail Bonds and 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star.
It's R&R. Hope everybody had a great holiday. If you're working... yeah, we get it. Hopefully it's time and a half. If you're not, what are you doing here? Unless you're listening to Fine Sports Talk Radio. Over the weekend, you know, Christmas Day is ceremonially, or at least traditionally, the ceremonial beginning to the NBA season. And the NBA, in their efforts to kind of expand the interest envelope, started that midseason tournament. And, you know, over this weekend, I didn't feel like I needed to have any desire to watch a lot of NBA. And that's the first time I can say that in quite some time. I know I was looking at watching our group text going on over the weekend as I'm going by the Saturday Morning Hangover Crew, a reunion of sorts, James Pledger and Jack Thompson. How much NBA did you watch and how much did you care to watch over the weekend, first of all?
Zero.
Yeah.
Yeah, very little. Strange, but right? I don't think it was because of the in-season tournament.
It just seemed like football was more important.
Well, A, it was more important because playoff spots were on the line. But at the same time, we had things that we aren't used to having. We had two games on Saturday, a full day Sunday, and a triple header on Monday, Christmas Day.
Well, the Christmas Day thing was.
Normally, that's not a thing on Christmas Day. Yeah. Well, so I think the NFL took over Christmas Day from the NBA because they had a triple header on Monday night that took all day.
Would you think that was a product of the calendar, or was this the NFL's attempt to say we're going to own this weekend no matter what you try to do?
Well, it's a product of the calendar. The NFL is going to own the day if the day falls on Saturday, Sunday, or Monday. If it falls on a Wednesday, there's nothing the NFL can do about it. Christmas Day is going to be the NBA that day.
They won't have the triple header because it's just a product of the calendar. Mm-hmm. That does make sense. And I'll say, at least by the calendar, the NBA held very little significance to me. And I don't want to say it's because I paid more attention to the in-season tournament, so I'm not paying attention on Christmas Day. It just felt like the NBA was a distant second over the holidays, whether it be because of bowls or the lack of superstars to go. I don't know what it is, but I think it's something NBA needs to address because I don't know what the numbers will be when we see them over the weekend, but I bet it's down because, again, the calendar.
Jack, is there anything they can do? I mean, look at yourself. You and a bunch of other people are in fantasy football playoffs. Yeah. Is basketball even going to get you to change the channel watching George Kittle try and get you an extra couple of receptions?
Yeah, I mean, I had players in just about every game yesterday, so I wasn't taking my eyes off the NFL games to watch in the NBA.
Like the NBA, there's nothing they can do about that.
No, there's nothing they can do about it.
There really isn't. It's a victim of the calendar. Over the weekend, the games they did show us, I mean, there were some good ones. We watched the Mavericks just pants the Spurs on a Saturday in a back-to-backer. Jokic comes back and really balls. I mean, he played really, really well. What?
Doncic.
I'm sorry, Doncic. He balled.
Yeah, he had 50 points.
Yes. There are reasons to watch. Yeah. We thought we'd get a good one between the Celtics and the Lakers. I mean, but
it wasn't a terrible game.
Wasn't awful. Steve Kerr was on the losing side of a Mavericks team where Nikola Jokic went 18 for 18 for free throws in a
Luka
win.
Luka Doncic. You got that in your head.
I'm actually reading off of a page where they've got it wrong. Forgive me. Okay. Forgive me. I'm actually reading quotes, but you're right. He goes 18 for 18. And
no, he was playing Joker yesterday.
Yeah, it was Joker. Yesterday? Yeah. I'm talking about the 18 for 18 performance post.
Yeah, I had no idea.
Steve Kerr was playing the Golden State Warriors were playing the Denver Nuggets. The Suns and Doncic were playing last night.
Mm. So,
yeah.
Cowboy fan, NFL fan over the last 2 weeks, Troy Aikman really sounded the trumpet last Monday night as to how bad the NFL officiating has gotten. Yeah. I mean, it is as bad, and everybody has a reason to bitch, every team. And that's either very good officiating because everybody's mad, or it's awful officiating. We're going to parse it as awful.
Yeah, I'm going to tell you that everybody's reasoning is not nearly as crazy as Micah's. Getting over 30 straight quarters.
Without being held?
Without a holding
card. Without being held. Micah Parsons has not been held in 2 years.
Leads the NFL in pressures, and you're telling me he's not getting held?
Well, you can say the same thing about an NBA player, the likes of which Jokic, who goes, 18 for 18 and gets a lot of calls. Steve Kerr, post-game, was not, I don't know.
He's mad.
He's mad, and this is about as far as an NBA coach can go when you're talking about the officiating.
I have no problem with the officials themselves. They're all across the league. We have really good officials. I have a problem with the way we are legislating defense out of the game. That's what we're doing in the NBA.
And the NFL.
We're teaching the officials. We're just enabling players to BS their way to the foul line.
And to a quarterback
sack. If I were a fan, I wouldn't have wanted to watch the second half of that game. It was disgusting. It was just... just baiting refs into calls, but the refs have to make those calls because that's how they're taught. So I have a real problem with the way we are. We've legislated defense out of the game in this league, and the players are really smart in this league. And for over the last decade or so, they've gotten smarter and smarter, and we have enabled the players, and they are taking full advantage, and it's a parade to the free throw line, and it's disgusting to watch. Thanks.
That's going to cost him, but he's right. And I think that that goes across two leagues, that defense has been regulated out of the game.
Mm-hmm.
That when we want to have great games, whether it be football or basketball, half of it has been legislated away. Half the game's skill sets have been taken away. And then you put things on top of no defense and then star treatment. You get a game where Jokic doesn't miss a free throw, mm-hmm. and in the second half just runs away because the foul line.
But what's the fix?
There is a fix if we decide to go that way. We either lessen the focus where we go away from it is what, the video and all of that, and we just go exclusively on the reffing. The refs control the game, where the league hasn't persuaded or done anything. If you get one ref, and I go to the old school in the NFL when Steve Javy was your ref back in the 90s and early 2000s.
Well, you were screwed.
Well, it depend. If you were a road team and you had Steve Javy, you were in a pretty good place. Because you knew you were going to get the benefit of the doubt because you were on the road. And every team knew it. If you had Joey Crawford at home, you were probably in pretty good stead because Joey Crawford was a home ref. You knew when you got Crawford, you were probably in a pretty good place as long as you didn't laugh at him. Now, you have no idea what to expect. You've got a Cowboy team that deserves most of the penalties called on them they deserve. They're not over-penalized because of unfairness. They're getting a lot of them, but you throw so many flags that the ones that you don't call or the ones that you don't call or officiate become that much more apparent when you're calling the Cowboys for 18 different penalties, but the one guy on their team that draws them gets nothing. It becomes very, very apparent. You either take the focus away or we go all in on this where there's a committee on every call. Where we all, on every flag, on every call, there is a committee of video and all this that nothing gets past a committee. And I don't think we want that either.
The sky judge feels like the fix in the NFL. Yeah. It really does. Because it's more than just like there's a committee. There's a singular person, a ref among refs, if you will, an extra official on the crew whose job is to watch the replay from the booth or from a sky view, and if a ref misses something, he buzzes down.
What do you do in the NBA?
I don't know if you can do a similar thing in the NBA. I don't know how to best officiate the NBA, because I mean, EZBX just said on our YouTube, Draymond Green never baited for a foul. No, but that's what's made Draymond Green who he is the fact that he knows he can bait the refs. And so he's become this kind of player that's constantly trying to bait him. Look at James Harden. James Harden is constantly baited refs into calls because he can. And so defenders are doing the same thing and trying to flop, which they're trying to also get out of the game, which is another thing, what Steve Kerr is saying, they're giving you everything offensively. They're letting you draw fouls. Now they're taking it away defensively to where you can't even try and get and garner a call on the defensive side without it being a call against you. So they're just officiating defense out of both sides of the league, whether it's the NFL or the NBA, because these defensive players don't know how to attack players anymore in the NFL.
Over the weekend, we saw the Spurs go down twice. The Bulls game was about what you expected. We had a pitch count for Wimby.
Against the Bulls, yeah.
He got like 10 minutes or something like that.
He was returned from injury. He was being minutes managed.
Well, not even played.
Yeah, and then he was a layup line scratch.
Well, he stepped on a ball boy.
Is that what it was? Yeah. Stepped on a ball boy.
He came down from a layup, was going backwards. And
I mean, it didn't even look bad because it's not like he landed on the ball boy. He was walking backwards, took like three steps, and then just kind of like, you know, when you accidentally like step on somebody's like foot, but it's like, oh, I'm sorry, I didn't see you there kind of thing.
Right.
That's what it looked like.
I feel like he could have gone.
He went out and offered 10 minutes of lackluster basketball, but that really wasn't the story that came out of the Bulls game. The story out of the Bulls game is now the rest of the world is starting to ask this very same questions that San Antonio Spurs fan is asking. Because while the NBA has done their best to promote Wimby and the Spurs have been on national TV, no one cares anymore because we're awful. But in this process of becoming awful, some very telling tendencies have been proven to be true. One of them is the rest of the team does not look for Wimby on offense. They just don't, whether it's by design or by omission or by commission by individual players. Wimby isn't getting the touches that any player of his ilk would get. Listen to play-by-play guys from the Bulls on Saturday night. This is the color guy talking about the Spurs and how they're using Wimby.
Brandon missing too. I don't know how you miss a 7'4" guy.
Yeah, how do you exactly I just don't understand the field of vision there.
Like, he's yelling, throw the ball up to the rim. Remember, he hurt the Bulls in San Antonio by just throwing it up there, and they wouldn't go get it. Man, it's almost like his team is reluctant to throw it to him. Wembanyama is your number one guy, and everyone else needs to find their role after that. Because it seems like right now, just from watching this team twice now, is that there's guys out here trying to figure out if I'm the number one guy.
Yes.
Am I the number one guy? No, I hate to break it to you. You're not. You're not.
Why hasn't Pop broken it to the rest of the team? Guess what? There's a new sheriff.
You're getting me worked up again.
Yep.
Like, this is criminal what's happening.
It is. It's crazy.
Like, they can fix this within their own team. Like, it's not like they have to go make a massive move. They can play better basketball just by adjusting the lineups and having a true point guard in there.
Yeah. It's not like a complete and utter fix of the problem, but, you know, there's answers in-house. Devontae Graham and Trey.
At least you're playing more competitively.
Yeah. And the offense, every time down the court, Wimby needs to touch the ball.
Every time.
Every single time down the court. Look at the Sixers and the Nuggets. Two best big men in the game. Every time down the court, Embiid or Jokic touch the ball. Whether they're swing pass, they're initiating from the high post,
yep.
They're drawing a double team and kicking. It's not a shot every time. It's probably not a shot every three times, but every time
the frustration is boiling over, because after that Bulls game, you heard it from Devin Vassell, another one of the young guys and one of the few I think that we think is a piece of the future with Wembanyama. Maybe. Right. And Devin Vassell, you can hear his frustration after that Bulls game.
I think just being a team, being a young team, we got to be able to know each other's strengths. You know what I'm saying? I mean, Wimby at 7'5", we got to see him. You know, when he's down there and whether he's posting up or if he's sealing early, we got to see him. You know, if Jeremy's posting a smaller guard, we got to know that that's a mismatch. We got to know that we could get it to him. Like, if I'm open at the three-point line, if I'm open sometimes, like, we just got to get it there. Like, we got to just be able to play to each other's strengths. I feel like sometimes we might dribble one or two more times, and now instead of Wimby being open on a lob, now they crack down to him, and now he's not open. Or if we over-dribble it, now I'm not open on the three, or whatever the case may be, and now instead of it being a good shot, it's a contested shot, and now it's a long rebound. We're trying to get back in transition, and it just trickles down from there, from there, from there. So I feel like at the end of the day, we just really got to – understand each other. Like, we got to understand. I mean, we done played 20 something games now. I feel like we should have more and a better understanding. And it's on all of us, and we just got to be better.
Devin Vassell post game after the loss to the Chicago Bulls, and what was not a terrible game all in all, but just lackluster and minus an active Wimby.
And once again, a third quarter meltdown, right? Was it a third or fourth quarter meltdown?
It was a third quarter meltdown.
Any loss to that team is a terrible loss. That's a terrible team.
And that's the situation we sit. When you play the Bulls, it'll be one of the few times the talent was relatively close.
Yeah.
I mean, we made a superstar into Kobe White, right? I mean,
he was a Hall of Famer.
We turned him into a Hall of Famer, basically what we did. Utah Jazz in town tonight. That's a team that's relatively slow. They're not a fast-paced team. This is the kind of team that the Spurs, in preseason at least, we looked at the schedule and said, Utah at home, that will be at the very least competitive. It should be a W. I think a lot of us looked at the season and went down wins and losses, and when you counted your 30 or 25 or whatever you saw, if you're an optimist,
the problem is at this Utah's point, win. I don't look at Detroit as a win.
There is no easy. There is no easy. And when there's never an easy, when there's never, hey, let's have some fun tonight kind of game, it just starts to wear you down. And I can sense it from the players. The Christmas Day tweet from Jeremy Sohan, I think, was very reflective of the mindset of this young Spurs team. And, you know, haters and, you know, why are you tearing me down or us down over the holidays? And, what is it? Hating and harassing on Christmas Day is madness. Sad people, man. Hope you find love somewhere. You need it. Feel bad for y'all. Merry Christmas. Stay blessed, everyone. That was our young point, our fresh-faced, optimistic young Spur reflecting this team. And at some point, there has to be a glimmer of sunlight. I mean, it's getting darker by the day.
But what's the glimmer of sunlight?
Wimby. You tell anything me a Wimby 30-10 win, maybe two consecutive wins. I'm not talking about much, but at some point you have to taste a little bit of success.
Yeah, but with this team, how?
You're not going to tell me that lining up against the Utah Jazz, as bad as this team is, that they're not so much under-talented that they can't beat Utah at home. No. I mean, there are games that you circle during the season that you almost have to fall out of a win.
But it's a lot like the Cowboys on the road or on grass. Do you have confidence in them doing anything? No, because they haven't, and they continue to prove they haven't. This team continues to prove that it's not a good team. It's not a cohesive team. It's not a team that will play well for 48 minutes. It's a team that will fall asleep for at least one quarter somewhere.
They beat the midseason tournament champions. I mean, what else you want? Realistic.
They have a banner.
It's the little things.
Do we hang a banner for beating the team that hung a banner?
I'll tell you what. We beat Utah at home. We're hanging a banner.
So,
down go the Jazz. On goes R&R. They are at home tonight. Make sure you catch the blitzes. They'll do the summer black preparation.
Mark's going to work.
The very least. We got more work to do. The Dallas Cowboys got busy on Sunday. They play again on Saturday. We'll tell you what they need to do to win against them Lions. R&R continues next.
It's the Awesome Tickets Pro Football Pick'em Challenge. San Antonio Sports Star. You're shot at $50,000 nationally, while weekly winners locally get a $50 gift card to Five Oaks Ace Hardware on Thousand Oaks. At the end of the season, locally, the best overall record wins the San Antonio grand prize of $1,000 worth of tickets to any event from Awesome Tickets. Sign up today at sasportstar.com.
At Lowe's, save big every day when you buy in bulk. Get 10% off select concrete mix when you buy one pallet or more. And there's more. Get 15% off select primed finger joint boards when you buy 10 or more. Visit us in-store or online for low prices on the materials you need. Because Lowe's knows savings. Lowe's knows pros. Selection varies by location. While supplies last, discount taken at time of purchase. See sales associate for details.
A holiday message from Jackson Hewitt.
Jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to get money the same day.
Starting December 11th, walk into a Jackson Hewitt for an early loan on your tax refund, and you could walk out with up to $1,000.
Jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to get money. Missing out would be cray.
Appointments go fast. Book yours now at jacksonhewitt.com. Early refund advance offered to eligible clients. Application required. Finance charge applies. Loans by Republic Bank. Details at jacksonhewitt.com.
The South Texas RV Super Sale is back at Expo Hall at the Freeman. And boy, do we have a great show this year. After years of supply chain and disruptions, our dealers are loaded with RVs. And they're making deals. A full array of Class A, B, and C motorhomes. Gigantic fifth wheels, toy haulers, teardrops, and pop-ups. So go on over to southtexasrvsupersale.com. Buy tickets in advance. No need to wait in line. We'll see you Thursday, January 4th through Sunday the 7th at Expo Hall. Doors open daily at 10 a.m. SouthTexasRVSuperSale.com.
Joel, I've invented the perfect exercise machine. It's practical, efficient, and fits in any home. I give you the Row and Go. Ta-da! It's a rowing machine that connects to your toilet, so you can row and...
Stop. Folks, at Quarter Moon Plumbing, Heat, and AC will help homes stay in tip-top shape. Call Quarter Moon, 651-5899.
Quarter Moon Plumbing, Heat, and AC, 210-651-5899.
License number M16004, DACLA 000743-458.
If you're hit by a car, truck, or commercial vehicle, you need help with vehicle repairs, car rental, medical care, Davis Law Firm can help get your life back on track. For over 25 years, we have secured important verdicts and settlements for our clients, some in the millions of dollars. I'm Jeff Davis. If you were in a car, truck wreck, or hit by a commercial vehicle, call the Fours right now. Call me at 444-4444. You've got it. There's only one number to remember, and that's Four. Attorney consultation by appointment only. Davis Law Firm, San Antonio. Davis Law Firm is a proud official partner, personal injury attorney of the San Antonio Spurs.
If you have unfiled taxes or are in debt to the IRS, this is important news. The IRS just rolled out a new program to help struggling taxpayers more easily resolve their tax problems. It's called the Taxpayer Relief Initiative, and it opens up powerful new options for people looking to get back on the right track with the IRS. And no one knows this program like the professionals at Optima Tax Relief, America's most trusted tax resolution company. They've resolved over $1 billion in tax debt for their clients and have the expertise and experience to help you. One easy call to Optima can start the process, helping to put an end to your worries of wage garnishment, asset seizure, and other aggressive IRS actions. Make today the beginning of your fresh start with the IRS. Call the experts at Optima Tax Relief now for your free confidential consultation.
Call 800-714-8422. 800-714-8422. 800-714-8422.
Optima Tax Relief.
Some restrictions apply. For complete details, please visit OptimaTaxRelief.com.
Injuries happen, and when they do, skip the ER and get to the OrthoNow Injury Clinic by TSAOG Orthopedics and Spine. OrthoNow provides walk-in care for injuries like broken bones, dislocations, sprains, and strains. Conveniently located in the Cory area with extended hours Monday through Saturday with on-site x-ray casting and bracing, OrthoNow has everything you need to treat your injury, and best of all, no urgent care or emergency room copay. Learn more online at TSAOG.com.
If you have unfiled taxes or are in debt to the IRS, this is important news. The IRS just rolled out a new program to help struggling taxpayers more easily resolve their tax problems. It's called the Taxpayer Relief Initiative, and it opens up powerful new options for people looking to get back on the right track with the IRS. And no one knows this program like the professionals at Optima Tax Relief, America's most trusted tax resolution company. They've resolved over $1 billion in tax debt for their clients and have the expertise and experience to help you. One easy call to Optima can start the process, helping to put an end to your worries of wage garnishment, asset seizure, and other aggressive IRS actions. Make today the beginning of your fresh start with the IRS. Call the experts at Optima Tax Relief now for your free confidential consultation.
Call 800-714-8422. 800-714-8422. 800-714-8422.
Optima Tax Relief.
Some restrictions apply. For complete details, please visit OptimaTaxRelief.com.
KTFM Floresville. This is 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star, your home for the Aggies. San Antonio's Sports Center.
Spurs are in action tonight, looking to snap a four-game losing streak as they're at the Frost Bank Center to take on the Utah Jazz. Tip-off is set for 7 o'clock. What did Sunday say about the Dallas Cowboys who fell on the road, on grass, in Miami to the Dolphins 22-20? We're talking about it coming up next here on R&R in the Morning on San Antonio Sports Star 94.1 FM and sasportsstar.com.
It's 0600. What's the O stand for? Oh, my God, it's early.
Wake me up.
Wake me up.
Wake up. Wake up.
Wake me up.
Wake me up.
Wake up.
Rob Thompson.
Ginobili the other way in transition to the back. Oh, the left-hand slam.
I want some nasty.
Rudy J.
Cowboys win. How else would you settle this game?
Begin each day as if it were on purpose.
I wake up in the morning, I piss excellent.
R&R in the Morning on 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star.
Good morning!
Hey, good morning to you. It's R&R in the Morning, a Tuesday edition. If you don't got to be nowhere, thanks for joining us, because we're somewhere sitting in studio, and you've had to be someplace. Yeah, join the club. Don't mind them brake lights. We'll get you where you're going. We are joined this morning. No Rudy J, as he's out till tomorrow in his place. It took two dudes to replace just the singular greatness that is Rudy J. We brought in this Saturday morning hangover crew, the overtime and all the special stuff that we'll talk about with two of our favorites. The Saturday morning hangover crew, that's James Pledger and my boy, number one son, Jack Thompson, sitting in for another hour of fun. We do have Clarence Hill Jr. coming around about 30 minutes from now, talking about what we saw over the weekend. And my takeaway from the Cowboys loss, it's not devastated sadness. In a vacuum, going into Miami, I don't care who you are, it was going to be hard. Cowboys had a lead with just a couple minutes to go. It's hard to ask for a whole lot more. And what was of concern was proven true again, that stopping the run in a time that matters is going to be difficult at best for the Cowboys. What my concern is something that's been kind of boiling underneath the level of anger and happiness over the last several years is the mentality of this football team. It doesn't matter who the coach is. It doesn't matter who has been around. They are not a tough football team. You put it best. I don't like the way the term is put, James, but it is probably the most apt. They're front runners in the best and worst case, as the description might hold. In the best case, yes, they're front runners in that they can score a lot of points and they get ahead and it's impossible to catch up on them because then they start teeing off. But they're front runners on the other side too. They don't have the intestinal fortitude and they don't have the physical size to stop or start a running game when it matters.
This goes to the two of y'all. I also want to throw it out there. 656 ESPN, 210-656-3776, or on our YouTube feed, go to YouTube, search at SA Sports Star, subscribe, like, comment along, let me know. Cowboy fans, what is your temperature this morning? Is it as an AFC team, didn't matter, San Francisco lost anyway, doesn't matter, or...
Because that's true.
I'm aware that that's true, and a lot of Cowboy fans lean on that logic. Or is there a self-actualization about what this team is or what it's always maybe been?
We had Todd Archer on earlier, and if you missed any of it, it'll be in our audio vault and brought to you by AA Best Bail Bond soon. I think Archer put it best, and it's something that's difficult to accept, especially for a team that seems to have so many pieces, so many parts, that the Cowboys on the road are just going to have to be perfect. And anything less, they're going to lose. It's not that they can't be perfect, but they're going to have to be perfect. They're going to have to start fast. They're going to have to get the turnovers. They're going to have to be perfect according to the Cowboy plan. And if they're not capable, or at least this defense is not capable of stopping a time-eating, ground-needing drive to end a game. They're just not, they can't. So they cannot put themselves in that situation. And to do that on the road, they're going to have to be damn near perfect.
YouTube Live asks, would they be tougher with Dan Quinn as their head coach? I don't think so.
No.
Because that that's who they are under Dan Quinn. It's not going to change with them just moving to the side. That defense is who they are.
Well, the sad thing about Dan Quinn and this defense, this is exactly what Dan Quinn wanted.
Yeah.
This is the defense that the Cowboys built. Now, they didn't chase some pieces and parts during the regular season, but the plan was to have nine safeties on the roster, mm-hmm. to play four of them at any given time, to be fast on the turnover, to be quick to the ball, but they're not going to win an 8-on-8 or a 7-on-7 driving running game. They're just not going to win it. They are not built to do it. That doesn't mean they can't because of turnovers and, you know, screwy play calling and the like, but mano a mano, good play call against good play call on defense. We just expect, given what we've seen in 15 games, that they can't stop the run when it matters.
No, there's sole person that did any of that yesterday was Tank.
Is there any comfort in the fact that at the very least, you know who you are? At the very least, it's nice to know, look, if we get in this situation, it's going to be difficult, if not impossible. So avoid that at all costs.
I mean, I've known who they are.
Yeah, the only
thing have they know who they are
is the temperament of expectation.
Well, do you think the Cowboys know who they are? Or are they still under the misguided belief that they can stop the run when it matters?
Yeah.
That there's this excuse and that reason and the reffing and all of that.
Of course they are.
Let me hear Micah's Edge podcast today. I'll let you know if they still believe.
Of course they think they are. I've never been on a team that, you know, you didn't think you were the best team you are when you step on the court.
But you do admit, like, we ain't good at this, so let's avoid that. I mean, you do get that, you know, in basketball, the best parlance is, hey, we don't shoot threes very well. Doesn't mean we can't make them, and we'll take them as appropriate, but we better live at the rim on this one. I mean, the Cowboys, what I'm getting at is, I get the sense.
Know your identity.
Know who you are. But the pressure that is now on this offense that we didn't think was going to be. We thought that this year the defense would hold the day. Cowboys, go score 28 points. You're going to win every football game. That's kind of the sense we thought it was going to be. That's not the case. Yeah. The Cowboys have got to score. It's not just volume. It is timely. They got to get out early and fast. The longer it's even, the other team is leaving. The longer it's even, the other team's going to beat you.
How would you feel more comfortable, Jack, if this team was Dak jumping out in a hurry offensively and trying to win a close game like that, or late in the game, it's close, it's been low scoring, but either Dak needs to go get you a score or the defense needs to come up with a big stop late to keep them from scoring?
For me, I would say,
who do you feel more comfortable
with? Yeah, getting up early. Yeah, you get the lead early. You can, you know, tee off. And there's always something about scoring points that leads to energy on defense in every sport. You start hitting home runs, suddenly you're fielding like crazy. In basketball, you start hitting some threes, you dunk on someone, suddenly everybody's locking up.
And the defense gets easier to play.
You get up early, you score fast, you punch them in the mouth early on offense. Defense, it just seems to come easy. There's more life is breathed into that side of the ball, and you're able to do different things. So for me, it's definitely getting up early.
Having Todd Archer on, he brought up something earlier, James. Detroit. Detroit's got as good a record as any team in the NFL.
Mm-hmm.
They're a team that has their own issues and dealing with some of the same issues the Cowboys have been dealing with. The as far as winning out, I guess you see enough problem in Philly where you think, you know, they could stub their toe.
Oh, absolutely.
But yes. The Lions,
they almost stubbed their toe yesterday.
Oh man, we almost had a brand new butt fumble. Boston, what's that kid's name?
Arguably that was worse.
That was as bad a play as I've ever seen.
He ran straight.
We'll get to that. But given where they are as far as against Detroit, this is a potential playoff opponent in the Lions. They could see them in the playoffs, knowing full well that the Cowboys, I mean, a couple things could break right and they could win the division.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
But the fact remains, the Eagles only got to get one of these, and they got two layups. They only got to get one of these layups to go ahead and win it. You're playing Detroit in a game that feels like, man, you got to get off the schneid. You got to get a win to prove to yourself you can beat a good team at home, at least. But do you offer everything against a Detroit team that you very well could see in the playoffs? Do you come into week 17 like it's week 18 and playing, you know, your guys for a while and coming in with a scheme that you're expected to win? But if you don't start fast, do you just kind of fold up kind of like what we saw against Buffalo, where you go real vanilla real fast?
You know, I hate the folding up shop in terms of like what they did against Buffalo, because it instills an institute of quit. That's why I never liked the term playoff games without playoff consequences from Mike McCarthy, because it feels like he left himself an out. Like, oh, okay, it's important, but it's not important. And I have yet to see this team play somebody not named the Carolina Panthers or an under 500 team. I've yet to see them play somebody with the kind of intensity outside of maybe that Seattle game, to which they were playing like it meant something right. The entire way through.
Yeah. Got to play with urgency. That's what I saw.
And it's a mindset. And it's a mindset Saturday. You have to cultivate.
Well, do you, when you talk about urgency, is it the urgency that you cannot get because you know you've got a safety net that no matter what happens, we're 5 seed and we'll probably be going to New Orleans? No, matter what we do.
No, I think it's a mindset.
It's a mindset thing. Like, we came out, of course, you know, first drive scripted, but everything was crisp. We're getting our best player the ball. You're getting them touches in the backfield and throwing it to him. You got solid runs from TP. You're picking up third and fourth downs on the opening drive. Mm-hmm. That's urgency right there. And then suddenly we get popped real quick in the face with a fumble.
Mm-hmm.
And everything changed.
How much of that falls on McCarthy and his play calling?
I don't think it's the play calling.
Okay. I don't. Yeah. I mean, there's definitely something to the play calling. I think CD got half of his touches on the first drive.
Mm-hmm.
That's the script.
Yeah. And then after that, I mean, he didn't get anything until the fourth quarter. That's your best player who was eating them alive. They had no answer for CD. And then they make an adjustment, and we can't do anything. If they are making an adjustment to cover CD, that is getting somebody else open.
Well, we saw late Cooks get one, although forgotten. Tolbert got him deep.
He has two catches.
I know. And Gallup had a nice Tolbert had the catch. Or was it Gallup that had a catch?
Gallup
late?
Had a nice catch. Gallup did have the late one. So did Tolbert.
So there were some open dudes, because I do think they were focusing a little bit on CD.
But two catches is nothing.
It's not a winnable formula at all. And you see them go away and you wonder, was it Dak that just didn't like what he saw, or was it McCarthy reacting to a defense that was, you know, they're going to take CD away, so we're not even going to look that direction. We get back to those age old questions. Who's actually controlling the offense? Because how do you go away and leave CD out of the mix for two quarters? Just forget about it.
For what it looked like to me is we're trying to get, you know, we were trying to force feed CD the ball, but they're bracketing him over the top and like under him, but we're still having CD as the first hot route.
Mm-hmm.
You've got to change that. If they're doubling CD, there's no one keeping up with Brandon Cooks. There's not a linebacker in the league that's taking on Ferguson. It gets stale. It gets predictable.
It's not even that. Let's say they're bracketing him, right? You find a way to get your playmakers the ball, right? You find a way to get your best player.
Is that on Dak or is it on the play call?
That's on the play call. Mm-hmm. Like, it's easy to draw up a screen just to get the ball into CD's hands when he hadn't touched it in a while.
Yeah.
And that was part of the issue going into San Francisco when they had that talk. And then they come out in the game against the Los Angeles Chargers, and you see them force feed the ball to CD. You see him get him on a end around. You see them get the ball in his hand in the screen game. You just see them make sure that he is involved every four plays.
Like Wimby. Gotta let it flow through him.
Everything else comes open after that.
What did you make of the Hunter Lipke experiment there in the first quarter?
I mean, it's fine.
It's fine. I thought, you know, goal line carry to him might have, on like, you know, the six might have been a little too cutesy of a play. Mm-hmm. Just push it in with Dak.
Yeah.
But first of all, Tony Pollard has literally has to score on the play before.
Did that tell you that they're worried about having a hammer on the line of scrimmage, or is that was an introduction? Like, we've always had the hammer. We're just going to start using him now. I think so too. I think that showed a genuine concern for the ability to move the pile. And they gave Lepke two opportunities to go do that.
But the problem is the fumble. I don't know who to credit because it looked like Dak was trying to pull it back a little bit.
Yeah.
And maybe like he did in that San Diego or Los Angeles game I brought up earlier, where he hit him with the naked boot on the outside. Like, that looked like it could have been what he was trying to do, which forced the fumble. But
it also looked like Hunter, he never really
had his arms open. And it was very strange. Yeah. I you know, after the play call and the intricacies between the quarterback and the running back, that's something that, you know, I can't quibble with that. I can be mad at it. It's something that I know can be fixed. You know, that's basic. But it was the play call that I found very interesting, given the timing, given the season, given the concern and the talk of it. It felt like a reaction to the press more than it did to just go get a touchdown.
But we hadn't had the hammer conversation in like 5-6 weeks. I mean, the offense has cooked long enough to where we haven't even thought about a goal line hammer situation.
We haven't had it very often. You're right. It hadn't been an ongoing thing.
It did look like we were force feeding it.
It did. But beyond that, I'm going to throw a statement out to you. When McCarthy is done, whether it's this year or next, will the death nail on his time with the Cowboys be their penalties? Will that be what, at the end of the day, defines what McCarthy has dealt with? A good to great offenses, good to great defenses, good to great special teams. But at the end of the day, the one consistent thread has been penalties. They reffed themselves. They penalized themselves out of too many important games.
Yeah, I mean, what is this, year three in a row of being the most penalized team in the league?
But it's not penalties. It's the stupid penalties. Yeah. It's the penalties that
pre-snap,
they can
avoid. The dumb ones.
It's either the pre-snap or like the, I'm going to hit the quarterback late, or I'm going to run into the punter. Like, the ones that keep drives alive that are avoidable, that they commit over and over. Like giving up a false start or lining up offsides on a 3rd and 4. Like, those are the penalties that are infuriating.
The playoffs picture, well, it's getting clearer and clearer. We're going to come back and look at where the playoffs are headed as we got games soon, baby. They're playing again on Saturday, including the Cowboys, a game you can catch early and all day here on San Antonio Sports Star. The kick's at 7. We'll be going before that. Coming back, we're looking around the league, the playoffs as they stand, and things that need to occur for your favorite team to get in. This is R&R, and you're on 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star.
It's Black Friday. The wife and kids are out shopping on Black Friday like most of the country's doing. Why don't you go on out to Golf Cup of Texas and play some golf or watch some football at the 10 Cup Bar, or go ahead and shop at the Pro Shop. A lot of cool hats, a lot of cool shirts, or maybe time to get that winter gear. I know they got some cool sweaters, some beanies, gloves, etc. All at the Golf Club of Texas Pro Shop. Get yourself a little something to eat. Get yourself some nachos. Get yourself some of those wings. I always get those lemon pepper wings. They also have some great burgers. It is the best sit-down restaurant on that side of town. And, of course, you know it is your football headquarters. Thursday night football, Friday night, Saturday, and, of course, Sunday. And the best thing about it is if one of those games run late, like that Thursday night game or that Sunday night game on NBC, they're not going to turn off the lights on you. They're going to stick it out because, again, they are the football headquarters. But book those tee times online for that Black Friday at thegolfclubofTexas.com. Let them know R&R in the morning sent you. That's the Golf Club of Texas, the friendliest golf course in Texas.
Federal criminal cases are much more complex than state cases. The court process is different. You have to have a lawyer with experience in federal law to navigate through it. If you have been accused of a federal crime or being investigated for one of the most important decisions you'll have to make is who will represent you in the process. The LaHood Norton Law Group has decades of experience dealing with federal investigations, federal trials, and achieving outstanding results for our clients. The sooner you contact our team, the sooner we can help. Call us at 210-797-7700.
Prescriptions require an online consultation with a healthcare provider who will determine if appropriate. Restrictions apply. See website for details and important safety information. Subscription required. Price varies based on product and subscription plan.
Hey guys, did you know there's a generic form of Viagra that works just the same, but is 95% cheaper? And you can get it online? Just go to hims.com/joy. Through Hims, you'll get a free medical consultation, discreet shipping if prescribed, a 100% online process, and trusted generic alternatives to the name brands. at up to 95% off. That's right. Get generic for Viagra, the same active ingredient as brand name Viagra, but for 95% less. It's the same medication, still prescribed by a licensed medical provider, but with zero copay, no expensive appointments, and no awkward face-to-face conversations. To start your free online visit, you need to go to this exclusive address, hims.com/joy. That's hims.com/joy for your free online visit, hims.com/joy.
If you didn't get that grill you wanted for Christmas, get into Five Oaks Ace Hardware on Thousand Oaks with one of the biggest grilling sections around. Five Oaks Ace Hardware has a huge selection of Traeger, Weber, Big Green Egg, and Blackstone, plus all your grill accessories and over 300 spices and rubs, over 20 brands of charcoal, wood chips, and pellets. And get a jump start on next Christmas. Five Oaks Ace Hardware has all their Christmas decorations on sale. Five Oaks Ace Hardware on Thousand Oaks near Jones Maltzburger.
Get a great deal on select Kubota equipment, the number one rated tractor brand for durability and owner experience in the U.S. The versatile lineup is built to help you make the most of your land. Right now at participating dealers, get a Kubota compact tractor for zero down, 0% APR for 84 months, plus save up to $800 on qualifying implements. Now through December 31st, see us or go to KubotaUSA.com for more details.
From the Gulf of Mexico to the hill country of Texas, Ewald Kubota is your Kubota dealer.
It's the Southern Recipe Small Batch Pork Rind Appreciation Day Celebration. Enter to win $5,000 cash, tailgating prizes, plus Southern Recipe Small Batch Pork Rinds when you pass the pigskin. Enter at PorkRindAppreciationDay.com. That's PorkRindAppreciationDay.com. And make sure to pick up the protein pack, bold flavors of Southern Recipe Small Batch Pork Rinds today at HEB.
America's best high school football players are coming to San Antonio. It's the All-American Bowl at the Alamo Dome, Saturday, January 6th. Trevor Lawrence, C.J. Stroud, and Micah Parsons played here. Join us for a day of exciting football to see the stars of tomorrow at the All-American Bowl, followed by the San Antonio Sports All-Star Football Game presented by Valero. It's the All-American Bowl at the Alamo Dome, Saturday, January 6th. Tickets on sale at the Dome Box Office and Ticketmaster.
Gomez Law Firm has been taking care of the people of San Antonio for almost 50 years, the leader in personal injury law. Jose, tell us a little bit more about what you do.
We do ride-sharing cases, 18-wheeler cases. Obviously, we've done those for very many years. Work injuries. We will be happy to take a look at it and see if we can help.
If you have been injured in an accident or hit by a company vehicle, then you need to visit joegomezlaw.com.
We've been around for almost 50 years, and we're not going anywhere.
Call the Gomez Law Firm at 736-4040.
This is Joe Reinagle. Join the Blitz today, beginning at 2. Shereen Williams from Pro Football Talk joins the Blitz at 5:15. We'll get the latest on the Cowboys and the NFL.
It's R&R here on San Antonio Sports Star. Just the beginning of a full sporting day. Don't forget the Blitz will be here starting at 2, going all the way to 6. And then James continues his all-day effort. Extra innings will take you from 6 to 7. And very quickly to follow, we have bowl football for you. It's the, we got tonight, the Guaranteed Rate Bowl. Forgive me, that just fell right out of my brain. I don't know why I didn't remember that right off the top. Have you guys watched any bowls yet? Is it bowl season?
I watched some UTSA, that's it.
I saw where UTSA lost
Trey Moore
to up the street.
Yeah, going to Texas.
Texas is back, folks!
Do we get them for the bowl game? Or the playoff game?
Probably.
Is that
not
how that works?
Probably not. The playoff picture in the NFL is kind of, it's not murky. I think we have a new best team in the league by most measures, as Baltimore took care of San Francisco last night. San Francisco's still in good stead in the NFC West. The AFC's still, I think that there's a lot of good teams in there in the top of the AFC. I will not include the Kansas City Chiefs amongst them.
No.
My goodness.
Terrible.
You know, earlier in the show, I was trying to pick a fight that no one took about the Texans. You know, just cashing in the chips, taking the money, calling us a good
day. I'll pick a fight with you.
No, you were. I think that my point would have been much better. But there's not the fear anymore of playing Kansas City.
No.
And especially knowing they're going to come and play you at home, probably.
Yeah.
No. They're going to win the West. You're not, I mean, you're still going to have to, if you're a wild card team, go into Kansas City to play them. The only thing is, if you're a division champ, and even if you are, you're the lowest division champ. So you would still likely, if they advance, have to play on the road.
Oh, I'm not saying just the Texans, but I think in the AFC, things have gotten a lot easier.
Yeah.
Well, I think that the concern about getting through the monolith, well, they weren't even a monolith, but they're just, they're not what they were. And it was evidenced yesterday by they were beaten on the most basic way you beat a football team.
Yeah. I mean, it's Kansas City in previous years, there has been questions, whether it was on the offense last year or the defense years prior, to where it's like, at some point, late October, early November, you start to see things start to gain traction and you see who they're turning into, and they're peaking going into the playoffs usually. This team is not. This team looks as bad, if not worse, on offense than it did to begin the year. Defensively, they've been dominant on defense, but that defense can only do so much for so long before it ends up getting worn down.
Did you see Pacheco take the knee to the head and then go to the sidelines and sit on a chair that collapsed underneath him? You want to talk about having a bad day. Watching Kansas City, it's a bit unnerving.
What do you mean?
Because I'm watching Mahomes now question himself. I'm watching him run around, look at guys, look off guys, run to the sideline, look around, do this, do that, go to the sideline, scream at everybody. We've watched him kind of melt down on other guys over the season.
If Mahomes, you were throwing to Kadarius Toney, would you not be losing it too?
But this is a guy who is so much further ahead than the rest of his football team. It feels very much like Aaron Rodgers like 2 years ago, where he's so much better than everybody else out there that he's looking around going, I am utterly alone, completely.
And that's the problem is last year, yeah, he did it without any receivers. Great, perfect. The problem is, he lost a lot of that offensive line that helped him to be able to extend plays, keep them alive long enough for some of those no-name receivers to get uncovered. He doesn't have that same offensive line this year. Orlando Brown Jr. is in Cincinnati. Like, he lost a couple of pieces to that line. It's not as dominant as it was. Therefore, he can't do it without the weapons because he's not getting the extra time for them to come uncovered on their own.
Do you think Kelce is going to retire?
No.
Do you think he can play as just an average tight end?
I don't think he's average yet.
Well, I'm just saying, what I'm saying is he's always been a star. He's been a five catch a game tight end. He doesn't block. I mean, he's a receiving tight end who now isn't fast enough to get open. Is he the kind of player who's going to look at it and say, I probably got three more years of average football, or it's time to check out a football and go get cash in while I'm hot, take some of this Swifty Q rating and go get myself another gig? Because watching him play, he is a shadow of himself. And even Mahomes, I think, is expecting him to be places that, quite frankly, he cannot get anymore.
I mean, I don't think he's done. I don't think he's washed. I think a lot of this has to do with the lack of offensive line, the lack of weapons, the more focus that is on him. He's still a five catch a game guy.
If it wasn't the Ravens, who's the best team other than the Ravens in the AFC? Did you see him in Houston this weekend?
Probably the Browns.
Yeah. I think we saw him in Houston. That's a good football team. When is Flacco going to get like third place in the MVP votes? Because he should. let me tell you, Joe Flacco should be an MVP discussion. He shouldn't win it, but he should be on the podium.
I don't know about Joe Flacco, but that early debate about Myles Garrett may have some water to it.
Because I don't think we want to give it to a quarterback. I think we want to give it to another player. Tyreek, if he gets 2,000, is a shoe-in. But if he doesn't, maybe somebody else like Myles Garrett might do it.
It won't be it, but...
We got our MVP coming. His name is Clarence Hill Jr. He writes for the Fort Worth Star-Telegram, and he talks for San Antonio Sports Star. You want proof? He'll be here next. This is R&R, and Clarence Hill Jr., Fort Worth Star-Telegram, is next right here on 94.1 San Antonio Sports Star.
At the YMCA of Greater San Antonio, you'll find countless opportunities to get moving and experience the joy of better health. All it takes is one. Find your why. Join today. Learn more at ymcasatx.org.
The South Texas RV Super Sale is back at Freeman Expo Hall. And boy, do we have a great show this year. Hundreds of RVs, every shape and size. All dealers are ready to sell. You'll get the best prices of the year, January 4th through the 7th. SouthTexasRVSuperSale.com.
Stop paying all those crazy fees on ticket apps. Need tickets? Stay local and call Awesome Tickets. Big games, big concerts, big events. Awesome Tickets is your personal ticket broker. Any city, any event. Awesome Tickets has your tickets for all the sports, concerts, and events from San Antonio to Las Vegas. Avoid the ticket app fees. Since 1994, Awesome Tickets is local and veteran-owned. Call 210-226-5136 or online at awesometix.com. That's awesometix.com.
Finding great candidates to hire can be like, well, trying to find a needle in a haystack. Sure, you can post your job to some job board, but then all you can do is hope the right person comes along, which is why you should try ZipRecruiter for free at ziprecruiter.com/free. ZipRecruiter doesn't depend on candidates finding you. Its powerful technology identifies people with the right experience and actively invites them to apply to your job. You get qualified candidates fast. So while other companies might deliver a lot of hay, ZipRecruiter finds you what you're looking for. The needle in the haystack.
4 out of 5 employers who post a job on ZipRecruiter get a quality candidate through the site within the first day. ZipRecruiter, the smartest way to hire. And right now you can try ZipRecruiter for free. That's right, free. Just go to this exclusive web address, ziprecruiter.com/free. That's ziprecruiter.com/free. ZipRecruiter.com/free.
Have you or a family member been arrested? The law office of Jesse Hernandez, the Texas Chancla, can help regardless of the legal battle you are facing, personal injury or criminal defense. Attorney Jesse Hernandez and his team are ready to fight for you. Calls are answered 24 hours a day and 7 days a week. Call 210-807-8656 or visit jessehernandezlaw.com. That's 210-807-8656 or jessehernandezlaw.com. The law office of Jesse Hernandez, the Texas Chancla.
Guys, want to lose weight, improve your performance, and increase your drive? Revive Men's Health San Antonio can help you address the root causes of weight gain, low energy, poor drive, and performance issues. And since your testosterone level has a direct impact on your weight and fitness, we'll give you a free T-check and free exam at Revive San Antonio. Imagine upping your game, losing weight, and getting in shape all at once. Revive can help you make it happen with our new cutting-edge weight loss medications like your favorite athletes and celebrities use. They're affordable and available now. Weight gain and low T are treatable conditions. We know we can help you. Take that first step and book today. You're only one step away from getting in the best shape of your life. Call Revive Men's Health at 210-615-7777. That's 210-615-7777 or visit revivemenshealth.com.
I have diabetes. I'm at risk for pneumococcal pneumonia.
I have asthma. I'm at risk too.
If you're 19 or older with chronic conditions like asthma, diabetes, COPD, or heart disease, or are 65 or older, you are at increased risk for pneumococcal pneumonia. Ask your doctor or pharmacist about Prevnar 20, pneumococcal 20-valent conjugate vaccine, a Pfizer vaccine that can help protect you against pneumococcal pneumonia in just one dose. Even if you've already been vaccinated with other pneumonia vaccines, Prevnar 20 may help provide added protection. Prevnar 20 is approved for adults to help prevent infections from 20 strains of the bacteria that cause pneumococcal pneumonia. Continued approval may depend on a supportive study. Don't get Prevnar 20 if you've had a severe allergic reaction to the vaccine or its ingredients. Adults with weakened immune systems may have a lower response to the vaccine. Side effects include pain and swelling at the injection site, fatigue, headache, muscle, and joint pain. For full prescribing information, please call 1-855-213-2138 or visit Prevnar20.com.
When you or someone you know is going through the process of being accused of a crime, you need a team to help you protect your innocence. Who better to fight for you than former prosecutors, now defense lawyers, that know the justice system? The LaHood Norton Law Group will defend your freedom. When you choose us, you choose honest, aggressive, trusting, expert, and fearless representation. If you need help, you need the LaHood Norton Law Group on your side.
R&R in the Morning on 94.1 San Antonio Sports Talk.
Good morning to you. It's R&R in the Morning here on San Antonio Sports Star. Rudy J in the hole today. He'll be back tomorrow. He's celebrating with friends and fam. But if you're celebrating a Dallas Cowboys loss, you're in the right place. For, I don't know if it's a celebration. Let's talk about it. We've invited in the experts and the first to arrive. And the very favorite one, that's Clarence Hill Jr. of the Fort Worth Star-Telegram. Merry Christmas to you, sir. Happy holidays and good morning to you.
Thank you, man. Merry Christmas to you. And how are you doing this wonderful Tuesday morning?
Well, it doesn't feel like Tuesday, does it? But it is a time
to it's crazy
to attack the week. You know, coming out of Miami, this was one of those games where a lot of good could come from it and not a lot of bad unless you walked out of there hurt. They go down late, but Dak closed out with a drive. What was the general consensus of the team? Was it one that got away that they felt like they should have gotten, or was it a worthy account of themselves against a very good football team on the road?
Yeah, you know, it was curious to me because the Cowboys felt like they acquitted themselves well. They held their heads high, especially after where they lost in Buffalo. And they're looking at it as, I don't know, they won't say moral victory, but they say there was a lot of good that come out of that they can build on for the future. To me, that's a moral victory because at the end of the day, you continue to lose on the road. At the end of the day, there are things you did that prevented you from winning, which you could technically do on the road. But no, you didn't get your doors blown off like you did in San Francisco. Didn't get your doors blown off like you did in Buffalo. Dak did come up with a gutsy drive, and you got to give Dak all the credit in the world, that offense all the credit in the world for coming up with that gutsy drive to put the Cowboys in the lead after they were down by 9 in the fourth quarter, 2 scores in the fourth quarter. They came back and took the lead. But when you needed it the most, defense couldn't get a stop. So I don't know how you look at it. Certainly they feel that penalties, that face mask, you know, on Clark, which the Cowboys continually, they lead the league in penalties. They continue to be their own worst enemy when it comes to penalties. That kills drives and prevents them from winning on the road, that fumble on the opening drive of the game. And I don't know, you know, the fumble was awful. But Tony Pollard not getting in on the play before was, to me, worse. How do you not? I mean, we've talked about not having a hammer at the goal line, and I guess they were trying to make the rookie fullback their hammer. But, you know, Tony not getting in on it would look like a wide open touchdown to the edge. And him getting stopped at the one, how do you not get in there?
Well, he got his butt in. He got his butt in. He just couldn't get the football in.
But not the ball, right.
You know, given what we saw, and, you know, they attempted, like you said, using Lepke as the hammer down there. And you brought up something else, the penalties. And that's the last bastion of losers, to blame penalties. But and I'm not blaming penalties on the loss, but it is 2 consecutive weeks where there have been remarkably questionable calls or lack thereof in games that really changed the game and plays that really did change the game. And it's your fault, my fault, nobody's fault. And a lot of it is just bad luck. But at some point, the penalties, whether it's their fault or not, it has to be addressed. This is going to be the problem of the year if they don't address it. Am I wrong here?
There's no question about it. And there's so many Cowboy fans and the Cowboys complaining about not getting holes on Micah Parsons, and you know, whether that was a questionable rough of the passer penalty, you know. But yeah, but TJ Watt is saying the same thing. You know, they're saying the same thing in Cleveland. You know, it's a problem, you know, and it's a huge problem because Micah's their best player, and their plays, you know, you think are game changing holes are not being called. But again, the false starts, the offsides, the illegal shifts down there, just is too many times. The Cowboys are doing it to themselves. The holes on Tyler Smith on offense is always somebody doing something bad at the wrong time, and it's really themselves. They cut out their own penalty. They don't have to worry about the lack of the holes on Micah Parsons. But it's always something for the Cowboys.
It's always something for the Cowboys, but it seems to be narratives. And are those narratives starting to work their way into the psyche of the Cowboys? The inability to win on grass, the inability to win on the road, the not being able to finish drives like they did early in the game. I mean, this game felt kind of like almost kind of a mirror image of what happened in Philadelphia, to where it was self-inflicted wounds in a lot of instances that kept them from winning this game.
And I'm glad you brought up Philadelphia, because Philadelphia was a game which the Cowboys lost. They beat themselves, but they used it as an example of, yeah, we lost, but we're playing well. You know, we lost, but we played well enough to win the game. And that was true. And it wasn't like, again, that was they had won. That was part of a stretch of when they won 7 or 8 games. Mm-hmm. And Philadelphia loss was not a setback. You know, it was another example of offense taking a step forward. And that's how the Cowboys looking at this, you know. You know, just in the locker room, you talk to everybody, and Mike McCarthy, yeah, we got to win the road, we got to win the playoffs, but we can take some good out of this. And the same thing with Dak, we can take some good. Like, they felt good about how they played, you know. And if the Philadelphia game is an example, then they should feel good about how they played, because it was part of a run. But at the end of the day, as I started out from, you know, you are what your record says you are, you know, and. You again lost your fifth game on the road, you know, and you still have yet to be a team with a winning record on the road, grass, turf, whatever, you know, and those are the issues. And those are things that, based on what you've done, you're going to have to be road warriors in the playoffs. And can you do it when it matters most? Now, you can say you're taking positive things about it, but until you do it, you haven't done it, and you're going to have to go in the playoffs without anything in your memory bank of winning against a winning team on the road.
You know, Clarence, as we head in 2 more games, they're locked in as we sit, it appears, in that fifth slot. We watch what Philadelphia damn near did yesterday with the new butt fumble.
Let me just say this. Nothing the Cowboys did in Miami hurts them from winning the division, because all Philadelphia has to do is drop one game,
right,
and the Cowboys went out, they win the division.
So how much of that played into the mindset going into Miami?
I doubt it. No, they know they had to win. They wanted to win because of what happened in Buffalo. There was not a mindset of, we don't need this game. Cowboys really not one to be looking at scenarios and saying the Miami game didn't matter, because the only thing that matters is the conference and division games, and the Philadelphia drops the conference or division game, and we went out, we're in. That was not part of their mindset, but those are the reality. That is the reality. No, if you know, and Philadelphia showed you again that there's something amiss about that team, and the Giants came back and damn near won that game, and so they have the Giants. You know, I don't know what's going on with the Cardinals. They have the Cardinals, and then have the Giants at the end of the season. So it's not a guarantee that Philadelphia is going to go through unscathed, especially with a road game at the Giants in the season. The Giants are still trying to play for something, because if that game yesterday was in New York and not Philadelphia, Philadelphia may have lost that game, and the Cowboys be back in the Cadbury seat with opportunity to win the division. So it's all there. But again, now they're facing Detroit, which is not going to be an easy game. You know, they're at home and they win at home, but don't assume just because they're home they're going to beat Detroit, because Detroit's a very good team.
I'm glad you brought up Detroit and the fact that game's at home, because I look at this game as a real opportunity for them to possibly lose 3 straight, with one of the flaws of the Cowboys being late in games, being able to stop the run when teams are openly trying to shove it down their throat. We saw it in Buffalo. We saw it late in that Miami game. Detroit wants to be physical and run the football, and the lack of a linebacking presence seems to be an issue for the Cowboys when teams vehemently want to run the ball against them.
Yeah, I mean, stopping the run has been, you know, the question since training camp. You know, they've all talked about it. They got better stop the run, and you know, they weren't. It didn't raise its ugly head at times, you know, for much of the season, because they have been playing so well in the offense, getting out the early leads and scoring so much. Other teams couldn't just pound the ball. When a team's able to pound the ball, it's a close game. That's when it's a problem. So again, which Cowboys tried to do against Miami. They took the ball and you know, tried to score, set the tone offensively. This Detroit defense can be had. They have to set the tone offensively to help that defense out. They can score points on the Detroit defense now. Well, you know, the big question for the Cowboys is Tyron Smith. You know, you saw when Tyron Smith is not on the field, his offensive line is not the same. You know, and that was also a problem, a huge problem against Miami. Mm-hmm. Tyron Smith is back. With, you know, if he's out again with that back injury, that's going to be a problem for the Cowboys offensive line. But they have to set the tone and help the defense out by, you know, scoring points. You know, this defense can be had, cannot stop the run when they need to. You saw that in Buffalo. You saw that against the Arizona Cardinals. You saw that against San Francisco. And certainly you saw that in Miami, especially they did okay against the run, but when they need to stop the run late, they couldn't get it done.
That's Clarence Hill Jr., the Fort Worth Star-Telegram. Make sure you're following him on all the socials if you want to stay up with what the Cowboys are doing. You brought up something, Clarence, that I find very interesting. You know, McCarthy and every football coach always talks about complementary football, the three phases helping each other. But does McCarthy, does that offense feel a little bit of added pressure that we have got to get points early? I mean, they have to get up early for them to protect that defense. And does that affect, or do you feel like that could be affecting McCarthy's play calling, or at least they're stumbling out of the block just because there's so much pressure to get an early lead?
Yeah, I mean, but they didn't necessarily stumble out of the block. They should have scored the opening drive. They did score in their second drive. But yeah, there's a you know, last week he tried to say, we don't have to protect our defense. And but yeah, yes, you do. I mean, that's where we are. When the Cowboys are good, when they're at their best, is when they score early on offense and get things going and set the tone with the offense. That is the pressure, but it's been their reality. I mean, if you look at how they played, certainly when they went on and won 7 of 8 games, is because they did get out and they did score and they did set the tone for the defense. And they did, that's the way they win. You know, again, the dirty little secret is that we came to the season thinking the defense was the best part of this team. And now we realize it's the offense. The offense is the best part of this team. The defense is the one who can be a liability. And they have to do things with offense to help the defense out.
Well, what do we know on injuries? I know it's short week. They're playing Saturday night at 7. Keep in mind, a game you can catch live right here on San Antonio Sports Star. We know about Tyron. Anything else we need to be worried about over the week?
It didn't seem like anything came out of the game that was the Cowboys no worse for wear. I mean, the question is Tyron. That's been the question that's, questioned all season. But it's, again, Tyron, it's a back, and those backs are tricky, and so that's what you worry about, because Chuma Doga was downright awful at left tackle. Letting the best pass rusher, Bradley Chubb, go free at least 2 times, not more. I mean, what are you doing?
Is right.
Speaking of what are you doing, what is it with the Cowboys to where every season seems to hang on the health of Tyron Smith?
Well, every team's left tackle, man.
Well, yeah, but like at least most teams have at least if there is a type of injury concern, they plan for that injury concern.
Well, the Cowboys did. They signed Chuma Doga in offseason. That's what they did. They have Tyler Smith there to eventually replace him, but they gambled. They understood that. I mean, if you look at his contract is based on a game-by-game roster bonus and all of that stuff, but they gambled that they could manage him and get him through the season. They knew that there were games he would miss. But again, I don't know if they thought it'd be 4. You know, he is not he's missed at least 3 games every season since 2015. Yeah. I know at least 4 games since 2020. That's a lot of games. And so that's been the deal, but they gambled that they could try to manage him and get him through the season and get him through the season healthy. But yeah, that's on the Cowboys, that's on the front office. But if again, left tackle is like franchise quarterbacks starting growing on trees, if they didn't address it in the draft, they didn't get a guard, they went for Mozzie Smith, and they could have kicked Tyler out and went with got somebody a guard instead of going with Mozzie Smith, who's done nothing. I've never seen a first round pick, just do nothing.
That's not like, true. You've so reported on Taco Charlton.
There you go, Taco Charlton. They could have had TJ Watt, but he didn't fit the defense.
Oh, Clarence, it's too early in the morning for us to start regretting all this. You bring up the injuries and the offensive line, and certainly that's going to be the absolute key here of getting Tyron back. But on the defensive side of the ball, is there just the acceptance? I mean, this is what this team is. And when it comes down to stopping the run, it's just going to have – we're going to have to scheme absolutely perfectly. There's no other fix waiting out there other than Hankins coming back, right?
No, you hope you get Hankins back, and he could come back this week. I don't know. He thought about – when we talked to him last week, and he said it would be hard-pressed to go against Miami, but he could be back for Detroit. You want to get Hankins back. And, that's one reason why the Cowboys would have to shack Leonard so hard, because they knew – they were undersized and needed help stopping the run. They certainly need to be bigger at linebacker. But outside of that, this is who they are. This is what they have to go with.
Clarence, sure. Real quick, what did you think of the – did you get a chance to see the Baltimore 49er game last night? And if so, what'd you make of it?
The Brock Purdy meltdown? The Cam Newton somewhere smoking a cigar right now. I just want to let you guys know.
I'm sure he is.
I saw him smoking them on Twitter last night.
He's smoking a cigar. Of course, to Cam Newton. But I mean, it's funny because I talked to a lot of Big 12 guys, and they were like, this is the Brock Purdy we saw at Iowa State.
Right.
And especially last year, and they're really surprised he'd been playing so well. And again, that's been the book. I mean, he's been a quarterback in perfect situations. You get your ball to your guys, but you put him under pressure, he will melt down and turn the ball over. Unfortunately, nobody was able to do it.
Nobody.
Until Baltimore did, and they did it, and he melted down in spectacular fashion.
Nobody does it like he does. That's Clarence Hill Jr., the Fort Worth Star-Telegram. We get him every Tuesday morning just about this time. We're glad you stopped by. I hope you had a wonderful holiday season, man. We'll talk to you next week.
Thank you, guys, man.
Clarence Hill Jr. of your Fort Worth Star-Telegram stopping by for his regular.
Of course, via the Buyer's Barricade guest line.
As he does it, finish that readout for us.
Buyer's Barricades provides traffic control, rental, and sales for San Antonio and beyond online at buyersbarricades.com.
I sit here as a champion.
Oh, yeah?
I did.
Fantasy
football? That only happens once a decade. and I've already used that up a couple years ago.
Still got the trophy?
I do. Still have that.
I'll let Bob know.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to. Bob's just gonna have to pass it through unless he carries on. I lost in that league, the Media Mics League, over the weekend. Well, yeah, I lost by 12.
That's not important.
That's not important.
So, what are you champion on?
I won the rib off cook off on Friday night. Yes, I'm sorry that you got there late.
None of the championship ribs left.
Yeah, I want to head something off at the pass. No, my ribs won. But my bacon candy ones, they were delicious and they were good. I was pretty proud.
I heard it was the garlic and herb.
The garlic and herb one. Yeah, I don't take credit for that because I don't think I could ever do it again. But those were really good. But the fact of the matter, that night on Friday night, the best meat in the building was neither Jason or I's. It was Joe Reinagle. See, Joe during the day.
He did ribs?
No, he did not. Joe during the day had gone and done a tri-tip.
He's like my meat big.
He does. And he brought some big meat. He brings that big meat energy. I need
more meat between my buns.
See, that's what he needs. And he brought a very well cooked tri-tip. Beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
It's been sliced up. I walked in and I got there late. I walked in and I was in a hurry and I had two racks of ribs. And I knew everybody was waiting to compete and everybody, the Yingling guys were there and Ryan was there with the video. And I knew that, and there's probably 20 people in there, friends and fam and supporters. And
wait,
and
Ryan had the video? Did he have a video of what's
well, he didn't have
down?
The video of what happened because it happened so fast. Well, I got in there with my ribs and Joe had prepared the picanha, which by the way, I had a slice. And Joe, you did have the best meat in the building. I spilled his entire plate of food on the floor.
The tri-tip?
Well,
All of it?
I was part of it. I didn't spill it. It was not me. I was just very close.
Wait, y'all fed me that tri-tip.
I saved some. But most of the good stuff was gone. I'm sure the stories that will be passed on today during the Blitz will be worth it. But I reign supreme, at least for the next year, as the rib champ of the San Antonio Sports Star. We'll see you tomorrow.
It's R&R in the morning. Follow Rob at Rob Talk.